Yo, people, welcome back to the YouTube channel. You already know what time it is. It's time for another watch along. Big up your damn selves in the building. Make sure you smash up the likes and subscribe. Guys, I'm in a great mood. I've just had a great day. I've had a good day. And these bastards better not spoil it. I'm telling you, I'm having a good day. I'm in a good mood. They tried to make me switch on the Elizabeth line. But apart from that, good day. Good day. I'll tell you about my day before we get into this. I got an incredible opportunity to go on to Saturday Social. Big up Sam for putting me through. You guys might know Sam if you followed the channel for a long time. We used to have Sam and Maze, who's now on, well, has always been on FCM Pod, but we used to have them on previews. You might see Sam doing up all sorts of madness on Sky Sports. And Saturday Social, we're going to be on this week with Fuizzy. So it's going to be fun. And that's going to get announced soon. So I'm buzzing about that. I met a Chelsea fan today at Zara. You know, I was absolutely surprised, you know what I mean, that Chelsea fans were outside like that. But my brother's still out there, you know what I mean, on the front line. Love to him. Gave me a nice little staff discount. I was buzzing. I was absolutely buzzing. I'm still buzzing about that. Picked up some things. And I just had a good day. So I just really don't need. And then on top of that as well, you guys actually forgave me as well. you guys actually forgave me for the video that we made a couple of days ago on the channel. The big ass skit. So the comments were great on that, by the way. I'm so glad you guys enjoyed that. Because when I'm filming these skits, sometimes I don't know if it's gonna be good. So it's good to see that you guys enjoyed it. And now we're here. We're here on this match now. We're going to find out. We're going to find out if the day is going to continue to be good or if it's going to be a madness. But yeah, we'll see. Lineups will be out at 7 o'clock. So we've got 22 minutes. And yeah, I mean, it's going to be very interesting because we just don't know what to expect today. Are we going to get a back three? Are we going to get a back four? I don't know. Those reports of us changing formation were just odd to begin with. I don't understand why we're briefing our own tactics. That's just nuts. Like, who does that? Like, I'm trying to think of another club that briefs their tactics. They brief what their team is going to do in terms of shape. Who does that? Like, the PR and it's just gone too far now. Like, it honestly just needs to stop. In terms of stuff like that, it makes no sense to me. Imagine if I was thinking this in my head. Imagine if we had done that in the Conte season. We'd lost 3-0 at the Emirates. Imagine if we just started briefing that we were going to switch to a back three. I don't think we did. You know, but anyway, it's a madness. But big up everybody in the chat. Let's see what you guys are saying. I am bricking it today. I'm not going to lie. It's a very different feeling to how I felt after the home game. Because I went to the home game. It was a snooze because it was a 0-0. But you know, I thought, you know, if we play in that game, you know, if we play similar to that but take our chances, then we could stand a chance. You know, we can come here and we could do something. You know what I mean? And then ever since then, it's just been an absolute car crash. So the confidence is on the floor. It's a massive game. It's one of the two cups that we stand a chance of doing something in. And, you know, it would do wonders if we could go through. Even though it's very much against the odds, we're not favourites, and progress and who, I think we have a favourable tie if we do get through. I think it could be Leeds. I'll have to double check. So yeah, hopefully, but you know, the confidence is on the floor. The boys have got to really pick themselves up. The manager's got to pick himself up as well, off the seat, man, on the sideline. I need him to be active, barking instructions, you know, trying to do as much as possible to rectify whatever madness is taking place on the pitch. Because all hands are on deck, you know. I've given my thoughts. I hate having, you know, sometimes other YouTubers will be like, oh, you must be so happy, you know. The growth on the channel is just doing so good. I'm like, no. No, I'm not happy. We're losing games. Like, I can't really enjoy this, you know. I'm fuming. I hate being negative. I hate saying that my club is terrible. I hate having to make videos and say that people need to be sacked or people need to be removed from their job. I hate doing that. I don't take any enjoyment out of it. It's not a journey. I don't enjoy it. I would love for us to just win every damn trophy and everything get 10K and it's just 10K Chelsea fans watching and the rivals are bored of us, I'll find a way to entertain you some other way. Do you know what I mean? But it's just, it's painful. It's very painful, especially for me because I wanted this guy in. So as you all know, so it's been very painful this last few weeks or last few seasons. I'm not going to lie. It's not nice. It's very, very bad. But, you know, let's see if we can get out of it. You know, it's just, we love the club, innit? What can we do? But it really does cause me great pain. You know, you ask anybody around me, when we lose a game, my whole night is finished. You know, you'd think I'd just go off and watch a film or something. No, I'm on Twitter, reading all the post-match int quotes, going back and forth with people online about the game. And, bro, it's just, it ruins your whole day, ruins your whole next day after that, especially when you're a content creator and people are now asking you about it. And now I got to go on Saturday social and I'm looking forward to it. Don't get me wrong, but I know I'm going to have to say some things that I'd rather not say. You know, I'd rather be praising and waxing lyrical about the club and the team, but I can't do that. So, yeah, it's just, it's not nice, man. It's not nice. I'd rather win. Anyway, let's see what you guys are saying. It's been a horrible week, bro. It's been a, I don't know what this week has been. It feels different to the others. There's something about this last week that just went by that was just disgusting. Like 8 goals shipped. Oh, it's just been peak, bro. and then people will roll up with the Champions League league winning clips, like you're mentioning, and the Tuchel celebrations and everybody diving onto the pitch. And oh my God, it's just painful. I actually can't believe that was only a couple of years ago. It seems so unrealistic and far-fetched to think that we are capable of doing such madness. Like, it's become so normal to be mid. It's mad. It's actually very, very, very mad. Listen, even though you haven't really seen me maybe in this position before, because it's very rare that when I call for a manager's head and directors as well, right, it's very rare that they actually survive the job after I've said that. You know, I said it after Lampard's first stint. You know, I think it was a defeat against Leicester. And then he got to the Luton game. I think it was. He made Mason Mount captain. Then he was sacked after that cup game. I never wanted Tuchel to leave, so that didn't apply. Potter, Graham Potter, he, you know, I said it and then he was gone. So this one, I said it and he's not gone, which I'm not surprised about. I wasn't really waiting for that. But now people be like, oh, what's this guy going to do now? Well, same as I've always done. I'm still going to just analyze what I'm seeing and I'm still going to absolutely beg for victories. You know, I'm not going to be one of these people that be hoping that we lose this game so we can get closer to his exit. Like, I just can't do that. I just, every game we turn up to, we need to win. Like, that's just the vibe. That's the mentality. What will be. But we need to win the game, and I need this win, not because of my Pochettino. I just need a win, just in general, you know, just need to win. So that's where it is, people. You know, we're gonna continue to try and be as fair as possible and give praise and criticism where due. But I'll try not to drag anything from the previous weeks into this fixture. Like, you know, we just go again, innit? We go again. And hopefully, these men actually turn up. Let's see. Nigeria 2-0 up against South Africa. I hope they do win that, because then if they can win and Ivory Coast can win, then that's a sick final, isn't it? That's the final. And then I'll try and cover that. I think it's on a Monday. I was just finding out that's on a Monday. I think it is. So I'll try and do that before Big Six, maybe on a Monday. That'll be difficult. But yeah, it'll be difficult, but I'll try and be there for that. We'll see. But yeah, looks to be 2-0. I did stop, to be fair. I did after that loss to Man United, I did stop. And then you guys kept being shit, and then you got too close to me. You was a point ahead of me, and then I couldn't help myself. So if you just take care of your business and stay away from me, we won't have no problems. But if you come too close, then I have a tendency to want to drag you down. You know, it's natural instincts. I have a tendency to want to drag you into the mud with me. If you are one point ahead of me, I'm gonna be pulling that rope to bring you. You know, it's gonna be a tug of war, and I'm gonna be pulling you guys in. So just stay away from us. It's not hard. We don't win many games. we don't, just stay away. You know, that's all you need to do. If you can't do that, then am I wrong? No. look. This guy must just be one of the most insane accounts on this website. I'm telling you now, for all the YouTubers, this YouTube account is one of the most insane. This brother is telling me he's not. Do you know what? I'm not even getting into this. Just go. Just stop. Just. He was born to disagree with me. I swear he was born to disagree with me. He's absolutely insane. Let's see. pen given to South Africa, no goal. Okay. All right, well, keep me up to date with what's going on. So in terms of predicted teams, if you didn't get to see the preview, I had a 3-4-3. Well, not predicted, sorry. This was my team. I'd like to see a 3-4-3 tonight. I don't actually worry about us creating chances against Villa because they have a high line and they very much stick by that and leave a lot of space in behind. And really, if you just play that ball over the top and time your run, you're going to get chances. The problem is that we're also conceding a lot of chances and the overloads out wide are insane. They're getting worse. It was bad against Liverpool. I think it was even worse against Wolves because the quality of the team dropped, but we still got absolutely destroyed at home. So we need to stop that from happening. The only way to do that is to really just, you know, look after Silva with some wide centre backs and add an extra defender in there to protect the pivot. Otherwise, I see Villa having a lot of chances. You know, they got a lot of threats. Watkins, they won 5-0 at the weekend. Bailey as well, I've always rated. Very, very good winger. Jamaican brother from Leverkusen. Great shot on him. So, you know, we don't really want to be part of that. So we'll see. We'll see how we set up and then we'll go from there. But yeah, I think something's got to give because it's been... We've been defending, you know, I'm used to us creating chances and not taking them. That's kind of been our thing for the last, I don't know how many years, since probably Diego Costa. What I'm not used to is the defense just getting absolutely blammed and rang-tangled, like, constantly. It should be a bit more airtight, very much more airtight than that, considering, you know, who's actually back there. I think the defenders back there are not bad players, but the structure is all over the shop. Let's see. Such a troll. Yeah, I've mentally prepared for Saturday. This is why I've tried to make sure I had a good day, you know? So I tried to make sure I had a very good day because I know that the end of the day is a tough end. It's very, very difficult. So I've tried to make sure that coming into this, that I'm in a good mood and then we'll respond accordingly to whatever happens on the pitch. But yeah, the game ain't kicked off yet, so we may as well enjoy that. It's all kicking off, yeah? It's all kicking off. Yeah, you see, for me, I've always wanted a Leon Bailey, Watkins, DRB front three from Villa. And obviously then you got McGinn in the 10, and you got your Kamaras, your Luiz, whoever else. Ramsey's been kind of out, injured quite a lot this earlier in the season. Buendia, maybe Tielemans in that pivot as well, but he's not got the biggest engine, so I don't know. Listen, but for me, that front three would have been great to see more often, but obviously tactically they've obviously usually opted to only play one of Bailey or Diaby and kind of rotate those two, and yeah, but you know, it would be great to see all three of them. It would be sick. We really, really would be. Prediction, not today, by the way, just in general. Because I actually want them to make top four. I'm rooting for Villa, you know. If you look at Tottenham, you know, you're looking at, just Tottenham really fighting for that last spot, fourth. You want Villa over them every day. So, yeah, man, the more wins Villa pick up outside of us, the better. Predictions, my prediction was... If you want my honest prediction, I do think we're going to probably lose. I'm hoping that at least we compete, you know, maybe a 2-1 loss. But part of me hopes that maybe we can take this to penalties as well. It's tough to see us beating Villa in normal time, but we got players to cause problems. I've said it before, like the the team is not as bad as it looks. I'm not saying this team should have to finish top four with the injuries they've had, but I think the quality that we have, we should be playing better football and we should be doing better than we are doing. We should not be 11th. We should not be behind Wolves. So there's you know, most people look for, they look for you to take a side, right? Is it all on the manager or is it all on the players? It's a balance. There are some players that are not ready to be here, but they are, and they need developing. I don't need to say names. There are some players that I believe are good enough and they're just not playing well and they're just not being used or, you know, set up the right way. So it's a mixture, you know, there's a middle ground. From first to 11th, we probably belong, in my opinion, based on the quality of the team, somewhere in the middle. You maybe sixth, somewhere around there would be more reasonable. But anything below is kind of, especially with no Europe, is ridiculous. So yeah, anything below those European places with no Europe is crazy to me. So, but yeah, that's what it is. Oh God. I must say I love Cams, you know. I really do. I love him. He's relentless. He's relentless. I haven't heard a Man United opinion from him in a good long time now. Every time I see him, he's always talking about Chelsea. But he said it a few times. We're not getting as much heat as we should be for the size of our club and for what we've done damage-wise in terms of money spent, etc. And I can't then blame him for shedding light on it. Do you know what I mean? He's trying to give us the attention he thinks we deserve. And to be fair, we should be getting destroyed, really. I'm not going to lie. We should be getting absolutely destroyed across the board in terms of coverage. Like, we are doing something that is unprecedented. For a team to win the Champions League and be comfortably, or not comfortably, but in the top four consistently, to then drop off into mid-table twice in a row is mad. It's mad. So I can't knock it. Put it like this. If I was him, I'd be doing the same thing. If I was a rival and this was, you know, if this was Arsenal or this was United or Liverpool, I'd be absolutely dragging them through the floorboards. They wouldn't be able to breathe. So I can't knock it. I can't. But his team is also not very good. And I'd love to hear more about that. That's all I'm saying. I'd love to hear more. But, you know, it is what it is. It is what it is. We love him regardless. He's funny, man. He's funny. I can't lie. He's funny. He's a great character. It's needed. It's needed, man. I like having these back and forths. It's good to... I just wish I was in a stronger position to compete, because now the way we're playing is just so peak that I can't talk to nobody right now. You should be pissed. You should. You're sick. You should be pissed. You're Manchester United. You're Manchester United. You should be pissed. Sixth place is not good. It's not even good for us. You think I'd be happy if we were sixth? I've said it before. Even if we made top five this season and you guys performed in the Champions League and didn't get your asses whooped and Newcastle and gave us the coefficient, I wouldn't be happy. I wouldn't be celebrating. You know, I'd just be like, okay, that's good. Cool. We move. Next season. Now what can we do? Like, it's all about winning. It's all about trophies. It's all about doing damage on Wikipedia. It's not about qualifying for this, qualifying for that. You have to, you should, but it's not about it. You know what I mean? That's not why we're here. So if I was sixth right now, I'd be saying, okay, you know, we're doing what we should be doing and let's kick on. that's where it would be. I wouldn't be, there's nothing to lift. There's nothing to take a picture of. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, man, you should still be pissed. You know what I mean? You should, and it's very close between sixth and down to like ninth or whatever it is. You know, that can change in 1 week. You can be in ninth or eighth. So yeah, it's long. It's long. All right, what's going on? I didn't duck it. That was recorded earlier than usual because I think Robbie went to Ghana with Cecil. They usually record on a Friday and I can always make time Fridays, but I don't know when they recorded. They recorded on a different day. So that means I didn't duck nothing. And by the way, there's nothing to duck because my team is going to put me in a position to get cooked again this season multiple times. We have Manchester City. We have Arsenal away. There are plenty of fixtures coming. You don't need to worry about me. We will be there. You know what I mean? It's not like as if it was the last chance. So, yeah, man. Ain't nobody ducking. But if they said on the show, because I didn't watch it yet, I just saw my face get clipped up and put on screen for some reason. But if they said that I ducked, then they're liars. They are liars. They are liars, cheats. You know what I'm saying? Lies. I've not ducked nothing. Nothing has been ducked. So, okay, I'll have to maybe listen because something's been said. All right, let's go through super chats. What is the worst Arsenal? What is worse, Arsenal finishing eighth or this? Bro, it's us. It's us. If we don't finish above eighth, then it's us. You know what I mean? Like, it's a pretty easy question to answer. You guys finishing eighth was bad, and us finishing wherever we are or wherever we end up is horrendous. It's worse. It's not even a convo. We're not in Europe. I don't know. I don't remember if you were not in Europe when you finished eighth, which time it was, because you finished eighth twice. I don't know. I can't remember. But for us, I know we're not in Europe. So I just know that is ridiculous. That's all I know. Robbie lied. Oh, Robbie said it. Robbie lied. Okay. You see, he said that and then he went to Ghana. Do the maths. He fleed, he lied and fleed. Crazy. How can you do that? All right. Villa versus Man United. So, yeah, this weekend, the plan is bro, when I saw the fixtures this weekend, because obviously we don't play until Monday. When I saw the fixtures this weekend, my mouth watered. Watering. My mouth is watering, bro. There's some mad fixtures. So, yes, on Sunday, we're going to cover the West Ham Arsenal game at 2. And the Aston Villa Man United game at 4:30. So I'm going to do a double. But on Saturday, there is a incredible game kicking off at 5:30 between Bayer Leverkusen and Bayern Munich, which we'll cover. And Girona are playing Real Madrid at the same time on Saturday as well, at 5:30. So I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there because I'm not going to lie, I haven't been able to give you guys much European football this season in terms of watch-alongs, but that right there is worth turning up for. That is insane. I don't know how they've managed to schedule that, but that is beautiful. That is what we ask for. Those two fixtures there, I will be there. Two screens, I cannot wait. I have been waiting to watch Girona this season in a full 90, not highlights, and I've been waiting to watch Leverkusen since the Super Cup win. So I'm buzzing. Can't wait to watch that. Good football, no stress, can't wait. So we're going to be doing that. And then Sunday, like I said, we'll be doing, yeah, you say you leave, yeah, leave me, leave us alone. Yeah, we won't be doing that. No, we will be there. We will be there. So yeah, I'm looking forward to those games. And then Monday we play Palace. Oh, we play Palace. So that's actually same time as AFCON. So that's that plan gone. So that's not going to work. Is AFCON final at 8 o'clock or is it at 5 o'clock? It doesn't really matter because I couldn't cover it regardless. But we play Palace on Monday, so it looks like we're not going to be able to... I mean, maybe I'll do a double. Maybe I'll do a double. I'll just get up on the other screen. But I when I watch Chelsea games, guys, I watch Chelsea game. Like, I can't watch another team play and Chelsea. I don't care who the other team is. You know this. So I'll put it on, but I ain't really going to be watching it. I ain't going to lie. It's just going to be there. If a goal goes in, that's probably when I'll look. So, yeah. All right, teams are coming out in about a minute, so let's get ready for that. This is going to be fun. I've got absolutely no idea what to expect because of these reports. I've got my predicted teams ready, but I'm sure it's going to be wrong. Let's see what Chelsea throw up. I'm going to do the Chelsea teams first, bench and whatnot, get up on the screen, and we'll put Villa's team up after. So that's the plan for the weekend, guys. That is the plan in terms of the fixtures. And yeah. All right, so Chelsea teams come out. Petrovic, Gusto, De Sassi, Badiashil, no Thiago Silva. Bella. Rusted. What did Bella do? Bella, what have you done? I'm joking. He probably was going to get taken out anyway, but that's mad. It's just the timing of it all is so ironic, isn't it? But yeah, he was probably going to get taken out regardless. But anyway, Badiashil, Chilwell in the back four guys, not five. So Caicedo, Enzo, Madueke. Wait, hold on a second. One, two, three, four. Oh my God, sorry. Gallagher starts next to Caicedo, Enzo, and then Madueke, Jackson, Palmer is the front three. So midfield three. Well, no. The way it's written, very scary. The way it's written is that Gallagher is going to be starting in the pivot next to Caicedo. And Enzo is going to be playing in the 10. That's how it's written. If it's not written like that, it's written as in Gallagher, Caicedo in the 6 and Enzo in the left of the 3. Which, you know, it probably will be that as well. It'll probably be a mixture of the two. Hopefully, it won't be Enzo in the 10. But it could be Gallagher in the right side of midfield, Enzo on the left, and Caicedo in the middle. I wouldn't be surprised if it looks like that a lot of the time. And yeah, front three, I'm guessing Cole Palmer's going to be playing on the left. He did play on the left for Manchester City quite a lot last season. We would have saw that in the Cup when we lost to them in the FA Cup and the Carabao Cup third round. If he's not playing there, then he's playing as a false nine and Jackson's playing on the left. I don't know which one it is, but we're going to find out. He could play either. We know Jackson can operate off the left. We know Palmer has played false nine. So we'll see. That one is up for debate. We're going to have to just wait. But Palmer can play left wing if you need him to. So we'll just find out. But yeah, back four. It's a 4-2-3-1 most likely, but could be a 4-3-3. So yeah. We're going to get predictions going in a minute in terms of the poll. I'm just going to get this up on screen first, and then I'm going to go through what you guys think of that team, and I'm going to tell you what I think of that team as well. Let's get this up. So, mad. No Thiago Silva. I wasn't expecting that, but I guess it is a cup game. Maybe this is the only time to rest him. I mean, it's a massive game. Can't really rest him, but you get what I'm saying. Maybe 3 games in 1 week is too much. He is old. I don't know. It's an interesting one. we've heard a lot about this Badiashile, De Sassi chemistry, connection from Monaco, partnership. We're going to need to see it. We're going to need to see it today. They got a lot of work to get through against Aston Villa. It's going to be tough. So let's see if they can perform as a pair. Our bench. Let's see what that looks like. So on the bench, we got Bergstrom. I keep calling him Storm. It's just more fun. He's on the bench. He's also doing okay for me on Football Manager, by the way. I can't stream it. I know people want me to stream it. I would if I could, but it lags. But I am playing that in the background before I get back to my FIFA this week as well. We've got Strasbourg to get back to. But he's been doing well since Sanchez is injured on the game. So he's on the bench. Gilchrist on the bench. We have Silva on the bench. Not Bella. Samuels Smith. I believe Samuel Smith, double barrel last name there, is a left back or left wing back. Or left wing. I believe he plays on all down the left. I think we signed him, correct me if I'm wrong, under this new ownership last summer, along with the Carney Chukwuemecas and etc. But I can't remember exactly where we signed him from. He wasn't obviously a big name. He kind of just went under the radar, but we did bring him in. Carney is on the bench. Chukwuemeka is on the bench. Mudrick is on the bench. Sterling is on the bench. I think that's good. I think it's good that Sterling's been taken out. That's the one positive I'll say from the lineup is that Sterling's been kind of maybe dropped or taken out, whatever it is. I think that's fair. And Nkuku's on the bench as well. And maybe not ready to start, you know, back-to-back games. So I guess for me, the only disappointment, again, is that there's no Carney. However, it is away from home to Villa, so I get it. But at the same time, I don't, because it's not like Gallagher's been playing well. So I don't know. It's tough because the balance of the midfield is always something that he's stressed with. He can't seem to find the balance that he wants. He wants Gallagher to probably be tracking runners in the deeper positions, but he also knows that Enzo, as a 10, he should know by now, is not really getting anywhere near the best out of him, and he's much better in the first phase and switching play and getting as many touches on the ball as possible. So the fight for midfield balance continues. And it would have been nice to have Carney out there in the 10 against his old club as well and helping us create chances in between the lines because we struggle with that. But he's not going to play him, so he's got him on the bench. It is what it is. I'm not even going to cry about it. Villa, what is their team? But yeah, Chelsea team was up on screen. Let me put that on play. Let's see what Villa's team looks like. should be interesting. They've got options. I don't know injuries where they're at the moment. But Villa are one of these teams that got a lot of depth. They've not really been able to show it because of all the injuries this season, but they've got a lot of players. Let's see. So Martinez starts in goal. Cash, Carlos, Leng Leng, I like to call him. Moreno at left back. Leon Bailey does start. Kamara, Luiz, McGinn, Tielemans and Watkins. This feels... I mean, no, this is as usual. This is business as usual from Emery. Yeah, he doesn't tend to play. He doesn't tend to play more than one of Bailey or Diaby. And I don't know if Diaby's even on the bench. Is he injured? People, what's going on there? Maybe he is. And then we have on the bench Jacob Ramsey to look out for. So keep an eye on him if he comes on, because we know how talented he is. That team's going to be up on screen. Let's see. I'm going to get a poll going for you guys as well. Just want to get this Villa team out. Okay. That's going to be a 4-3-3. Could be even a 4-4-2. I mean, Bailey and Watkins could play as a front line, and then McGinn, Tielemans, Luiz, and Kamara across the midfield. I think in and out of possession, they'll be different regardless. It'll be a different situation in and out of possession. We have to keep an eye on that. I'm trying to think who plays on the left in that team, because obviously no Jacob Ramsey, what's his name? The guy that he's mad big injury, Zaniolo, that's it. Yeah, he's on the bench as well. So I'm not actually sure how that team who shapes up on the left. You guys will let me know in the comments. It's been a while since I watched Villa. All right, let's get the poll up. I'll get the bench up in a minute for Villa. Let's get the poll up. I want to see what you guys are telling me. Villa versus Chelsea predictions. I'm going to go through your comments, don't worry, on that team. I'm going to talk more about that team. I'm kind of still taking it in. And it looks like the back three briefings were bullshit because it's not happened. Or they were trying to make Villa second guess. I have no idea. Do you know what? Let me redo that poll, because there's no point having a draw, because only one, there is no draw here. It's one team's going through or not. So let's just cut to the chase. Let's just cut to the chase with that one, shall we? Either Villa go through. Let's go normal time. Chelsea go through normal time. Or it's pens for Villa. Don't know if there's extra time, but... Or it's Chelsea. Pens. All right, cool. Let's get that up. All right, there we go. That's up. So McGinn plays left. Okay, cool. Yeah, because you see, McGinn is kind of like a floater, isn't he? McGinn can pick up the ball all across these positions behind the forward. He's such a good player. So intelligent. Works his absolute arse off as well. Sometimes he's in the 10. I'm seeing him in the 10. Sometimes I'm seeing him come off the right and linking up and doubling up with the winger. And then obviously, yeah, off the left as well. So yeah, he's a top player for them. Top player. Just very, very secure in everything that he's doing in that position. Very, very good. Good season he's having. All right, so just getting their bench written up. Get your votes in if you haven't already. Pau Torres is on the bench. Chambers is on the bench. Right, Diaby as well. So Diaby is on the bench, guys. So he's not injured. I don't know why. So yeah, he's just on the bench. So he's just really rotating between the two. Ramsey on the bench. Kellyman on the bench as well. And cool. Not really familiar with these other brothers. Okay. I don't think the lineup was really going to make a massive difference today in terms of confidence levels, to be honest. I think that's kind of coming from previous fixtures and the mood and everything going on at the club. So I don't think the team really was going to change anybody's levels of optimism coming in. We just, because it's really all just about, it's about the way we play now. It's, you know, it's about the setup. It's about the style going forward. It's about the way we defend. It's not even just personnel. Personnel is least of our problems right now. Right. All right, that's on screen. I hope that's in rotation, but we'll find out in a minute. I mean, listen, I don't think we have to worry about whether Osherman is good enough or he's not for that price, because I really don't think we can afford him. So, you know, I really don't think we can afford him, but we're going to find out. We're going to find out. Diaby's a pace merchant. Nah, Diaby's a good player. Diaby's a good player. He's a good player. He might be going through a rough patch, but he's a good player. He's not injured. He's on the bench. Let's see. Madueke or Palmer, left wing. Yeah. So I've seen Madueke play left for the under-21s for England sometimes. He's never played left for Chelsea. And I don't think he can play left right now. I really don't. I think he needs to stick to his strongest position, cutting in and trying to cause problems that way. So it is either Palmer or it's Jackson for me. It won't be Madueke. It'll be Palmer or Jackson. Or interchange. So we'll find out, you know. I don't really see how else we're going to play. Obviously, if we were playing with wing backs, it'd be a different story, but we're clearly not, because we've only got two centre backs out there. There's no silver. So we are playing the normal formation, which is 4-2-3-1/4-3-3, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, we're gonna see on that left wing spot. I think it will probably be Palmer. I don't know. No, actually, I don't know. It could be Jackson, to be honest. It really could. It could. I'm trying to think what the thinking is here, because their centre backs, well, they're going to be back up on screen in a minute. I'm trying to think what is the logic here in as to who would be the better option to play as a striker. For me, Jackson should just be up front, because he's Palmer's not a striker. And when Palmer plays up there, sometimes he gets lost and he doesn't get as involved in the game as we'd want him to. And it's just not natural to him. He's just doing a job. And he's one of our best players at the moment. So we don't really want to be sacrificing his game. So for me, I'd always be trying to put Jackson there before Palmer and get Palmer in his natural position. But left wing, I haven't seen Palmer on the left wing for about, a year? So I don't even know what left wing Palmer is going to do today, but I'd be intrigued to find out. Yes, I agree. I think Chilwell's pretty limited in build up. I've always said that. You know, I think that's why wing back really suited him under Tuchel, because he was not really so deep in the build up. He was kind of allowed to make those runs and get far forward and stretch teams. And for me, when he's in build-up, I just feel like he's very limited and predictable. He doesn't really use his right foot at all. He can be pressed. His touch sometimes gets, you know, himself into trouble. So he's not as technically clean and smooth as, say, Lewis Hall or Mattson, in my opinion, technically. And I said that in the summer. I thought technically these two players have much higher ceiling. Physically, Chilwell obviously, you know, has got an engine when he's pre-injury. Experience can deliver a top performance, don't get me wrong, but he's now had the injuries. We don't really know what we're getting, and he shouldn't be captain. You know, he's not ready to be captain. I'm sorry, I saw the post-match interview after Liverpool, and it against Wolves, you could just tell he's not a captain. Like, you can just tell he's out of his depth. He is. But so is everybody, isn't it, when they put that armband on. So let's see. But there isn't anybody else to play in that position. Colwell's rehabilitating, so he's not ready to start. And he was getting cussed enough time at left back, and he still, you know, is not the solution over there, because he was getting destroyed by wingers, and you know, he's just not the guy out there to close down wingers and stop them from doing what they want. So we don't have a left back until the left backs perform, you know, and Chilwell and Kukure, the guys over there, they have to play and they have to perform. They're on 200K a week. They've got to deliver. They're two of the most experienced players in the squad. We look at these experienced players and we're not really able to lean on any of them. You know, Chilwell, people want him out the team. No, not disagreeing at all. But again, he has to play because of the options. But he should be one of the people that we're relying upon. Now, he is coming back from the injury. So maybe that's a reason as to factor in his performances. But he's got to be one of the players that we lean on, really. But can we? The experienced players in this team, they're not spine worthy. So it's a problem. They're not spine worthy. So it's a big problem to look to them for guidance in these moments. I think it's on ESPN Plus in America. Where is this in the UK? Please tell me I don't have to be out here doing a madness again. Surely they're just going to give me this game, man. They didn't give me the Wolves game. It's a Wednesday night. Nobody else of this level is playing. Please just put us on the TV, for God's sake. Come on, man. Don't make me beg. ITV, rotted. Now we're talking. Now we are talking. Now we're getting somewhere. Good. That's one less problem. Cool. What else was I going to say? Let me just... We're not winning the kickoff anyway. What the hell is that? Oh, dear. You're funny. Man said, what is that? Oh, my days. Kickoff is at 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock kickoff. Super chats. Right. So, we want Chelsea... Leeds. You're a Leeds fan, yeah? You want Chelsea. Okay. Is it just Leeds? Are Leeds already through? So it's just Leeds. It's not Leeds or someone else, right? I wasn't sure. Would love to see all the midfielders sit in a three and two stay back. One ventures forward when and they rotate on the game progress with Enzo spraying. I would just love Enzo to just get significant touches. I'm not even asking for all this. Like, I'm just going to strip it back to just Enzo on the ball as much as possible. If you want to get the best out of Enzo Fernandez, you get him on the ball as much as possible with options around him in terms of people making runs and movement ahead of him. And I still maintain that he is one of the best passers out there to pick out these people. Like, his passing for me is certy. It's very much certified. It's done. It's there. It's just whether or not, A, we give him the ball in the areas where he can hurt teams, and B, whether we have movement. There's other parts of his game that, you know, dip in and out and we have to worry about, but passing is not one of them. He leads, I think he's one of the leaders this season in through balls played, which is ridiculous considering he's always making runs in the half spaces and doing all sides. They got him doing all types of foolishness. This guy is passing... He should be the guy that we look to play those passes and to dictate. Now, obviously, he's also got to take responsibility as well. You know, I want him to level up and perform and put the work in. But, you know, I do think he's being misused. I don't want to... I said it first 10 minutes against Middlesbrough in the previous round when this guy was making runs in behind the striker. And people would be like, oh, it's not that bad. You're being negative. I said, bro, it's Enzo Fernandez. Why is he making runs in behind the defensive line of Middlesbrough? It's wrong. It's actually just wrong. It's not, there's no, oh, it's a low block. You think Man City would do that? You think Pep would use him like that? Come on, man. Like, he's not Julian Alvarez. This brother is not an eight to be making runs in behind. He's not that type of eight. He's not Bellingham. He should be on the ball. If you got low block and you're not using this guy to pass, then I don't know what we're doing. You may as well just get rid of him. So, yeah, hopefully we're gonna see him used correctly today, and then it's on him to perform. You know what I mean? And him and Caicedo, I need them to strike up this relationship, this chemistry. I still believe our midfield is one of the most exciting parts of our team in terms of the quality that we've brought in terms of Caicedo and Lavia and Enzo. I think it can work. If it doesn't work with this manager, which it's not, then no problem. We will find another manager for it to work, because one manager will make this work. You will. You must. You absolutely must make it work. It's non-negotiable. You must make this work. This midfield, you will make it work. You must. There's too much potential and quality in there to not get those guys playing. All right, let's see. Zero hope for this game. Yeah, there's no back three. No back three. And I said in the preview today, I'm gonna pick a back three, right? Because I can't watch these centre backs getting twisted up in the wide areas anymore. The Silvers, and you know, I need some help in there. The defense is getting absolutely cooked now. I'm gonna need to throw one more person back there. I just don't care anymore. And it's Villa away, so it's an easy game to do it. It's not like we're at home to Luton or Burnley. But I said in the Pochettino predicted, I'm gonna leave it in the back four because I really just don't believe that he's gonna flip it right now. So I'm gonna just wait to find out if he does before I say that he will, because I'm not seeing it personally. You know, he's been playing the back four all season. He did it in preseason. I think he wants to play that way. So I didn't want to just go with that report because, nah, just didn't feel right. Big game for Badiashil. Yeah, spot on. Massive game. He needs to have a performance. He's been very, very shaky, man, of late. He's been making some massive errors. Those errors against Liverpool, I mean, it's just so unlike him. If you're talking about him last season, it's night and day. I don't know how we've got to this point. Obviously, he had the injury and whatnot, but he was so reliable for the period that he was available for us last season. So consistently on point, calm, composed. Like, he was just... The thing is, when Badiashil's at his best, he's just one of those players you don't even have to worry about. Like, when Badiashil's playing confidently at his best and performing to the level we've seen him and I think he can even surpass, you don't even look twice with this brother. You just leave him to do his job because he just oozes composure and calmness. But recently he's just been moving mad. You know, yeah, I've been bricking it with him. Touches are heavy, not playing offside traps correctly, making errors, not tracking runners, like, you know. Him and Colwell will fight for that position to the end of time. And that's just how it will be. Until I see anybody play them together, two left-footers in a centre-back pairing, I'm still yet to see it. But them two can fight for that position to the end of time. I think they both got potential, but he's been very shaky. So he ain't nailed on in that position right now. All right, we need Fofana. To play the high line, we do. Yeah, to play a higher line, we do. But again, I'm going to stress, what version of Wesley Fofana are we going to get now? Because this is what, his second or third big injury? He's still very young. Are we going to get Leicester debut season Fofana? Or are we going to get something else? I don't know. So I'm very worried about that. That investment there is crazy. 80 million and, he's not even been able to really play. How many games has he played for us? I'm not even sure. I don't feel like it's more than 10. It's definitely not more than 15. So yeah, I don't know, man. That investment is looking very scary, very shaky. The potential was there. I think he would have been right up there with one of the best young centre-backs in this league. You know, people talk about Konate, Saliba, the French connection, and they're having their big battle. I think if Fofana could have stayed, you know, it's not his fault, obviously. But if he was fit, I think he would have been right with them. I really do. What I saw in that Leicester debut season was one hell of a centre-back. I mean, we saw it up and close and personal against us in the FA Cup final when we lost 1-0 to that Tielemans goal. He was man of the match. So the potential was really clear. But I don't know. After these injuries, I don't know what we're going to get, man. So... Osimhen off before Pens is insane. Is it still level in that game? I thought that. Oh yeah, because you guys said the goal was disallowed, isn't it? So it's 1-1, and he's come off before penalties. Well, he didn't take a penalty earlier on in the tournament. It was someone else that took it, isn't it? So, yeah, I don't know. He doesn't take pens. Does he take pens for Napoli? Or is it someone else that's taking them? Still, to take him off when you need a goal is crazy. Is he not playing well? What's going on? For him to come off when you need a goal, I'm shocked. And it's a shootout. So he might not take the pens, but there's going to be five takers. Surely he's going to be one of them. There's no way Nigeria got five better takers than him. That's mad. All right. Girl cries over about it. He's not going to do that because he's already screaming about a lack of height. So he's not going to be them throwing him into centre back. He won't be doing... Gilchrist won't be playing centre-back on the poch. I'll tell you that now. He's playing full-back like a... is he Scottish? Like a Scottish Aspilicueta. And that's as far as it's going to go. You ain't going to see that brother at centre-back. Is he Scottish? I think he is, isn't he? Feels very much like a Scottish name. No, he's English. He must have some Scottish in him. Let me see. Okay, maybe I'm wrong. Do you know what it is? It's his playing style. It's the way that he just gets stuck in. He reminds me of, you know, you got your Scott Browns, Gilmore. I know he's very small, but when he first came into the Chelsea first team, he was really getting stuck in. Like he was being a nasty little bastard, but in a good way. The Scotsmen they do get their hands dirty. They don't play around in this sport. They like to make their challenges. So he just gave me that vibe, but maybe he's not. Lavia Caicedo 6'8 hybrids, Enzo 8'10 hybrid. Yeah, if it's Football Manager in it, it's kind of like that, you know, kind of situation. But everybody involved in the build-up, man, or, you know, take it in turns, but they're all first phase. They're all able to play in that first phase. Not able to play in the final phase. I don't think anybody there is a goal scorer. Enzo is the only one that maybe can crash that box and get goals. His shooting from long range still needs to be better. The other two are just going to get their 1-2 customary goals a season. But this is why then you need an absolutely prolific front three. That midfield three is not a problem if you get a prolific front three in front of them. And then they just, you know, they just progress that play through to them and you can do damage. The only thing you could say with that midfield is it too lightweight? Does it not have enough height or strength in there? But I'm not trying to answer that question until 2-3 years down the line and we've seen them consistently and we give it a go. You know, right now we haven't even seen them all because the one's been injured the whole season. So every team always lacks something, but you know, it's how you mask it and how you play with it, how you play around it. So who's the one playing Enzo as a second striker? That would be Pochettino. You know, it's nobody else unless Jesus Perez is starting to get in on the tactics. All right, cool. The Gallagher persistence is draining. Yeah, I'd say that's probably out of everything the one that I'd rather change the most in this team. I think I think the rest of the team, I ain't really got any complaints. Not everybody in that team is on form, obviously, because we've been poor in the last week. But I think if I was to change one thing, I think I'd be wanting to see Carney Chukwuemeka over Gallagher at this point. You know, I had Gallagher to come out the game against Wolves and I would have had him in this one too, I think, as well. I've got it in that 3-4-3, I would have had him. Yeah, I would have had him on the bench. He wasn't in my team. So yeah, Gallagher. Carney's the more exciting player. He's the more exciting, technically secure player. But again, defensively, maybe he's looking at Gallagher to cut out, you know, Villa's attacks and all of those situations that on transition we might be caught in. At this point, I just win the damn game. Just win the damn game. We don't have a Xhaka. He's a very rare player. Very rare player. But he's smashing it, isn't it, this season? So smashing it this season at Bayer Leverkusen. All right. Let's check the predictions, what's being said in this poll. Make sure you smash up the likes if you haven't already, people. If you're just coming in, 1.7k of you in here. I don't even know what the likes are even at because it's not showing me. Villa go through in normal time, 66%. Chelsea go through in normal time, 19%. Villa on pens, 5%. Chelsea on pens, 10%. It's over 1,000 votes. Pretty comfortably Villa in normal time for most, which is fair. That's a fair. Carney's come back from long-term injury. He cannot start the game. I mean, listen, we don't know. May, if that's the reason and you're just easing him in, you want to look after him, then of course that's not a problem because we don't want anybody to get injured again. We don't know though, because Nkunku started the other day and he was out for just as long and it was a reoccurring, I think it was a different part of the body, but it was a second injury in quick succession. Carney was out for a while, but then he was back and then he got another injury in quick succession. So him and Nkunku this season have probably been missing for just as many games as each other. I don't know what the situation is. Obviously, they've had different injuries and all this stuff. So that's just knowledge that I'm not privy to. I don't know if he's ready to start or not. I just hope that if he was ready to start, then he could have played. If he's not ready to start, and he says that in the post-match, if he's asked, then obviously it doesn't matter. It is what it is. But yeah, I would have liked for him to start if he's able to. How bad are we missing Lavia? It's not an excuse. Not having Lavia doesn't mean that we should be, you know, performing like this. There's no one player in this team that should mean that we're performing like this, to be completely honest. Lavia, though, is very talented. I really, really enjoyed him last season at Southampton, especially in a team that got relegated. Him and Ward-Prowse showed that they were many cuts above the rest of them. Against Manchester City in the Cup, against Arsenal at the Emirates, he put in some big performances. So again, very talented, very excited when he joined, still excited to have him, but we haven't seen him. So it kind of, at this point, is non-existent, you know, in terms of we don't know what we're getting with him because we've not seen him. So, and we don't know how he's going to recover from the injury. And there's no timeline on when he comes back. So it's a mess. It's a real mess. It's a shame because he's kind of taken all my enthusiasm away from the signing. But I still rate him, obviously. So hopefully when he comes back, we can use him next to Caicedo and make it work with Enzo. I think that midfield three should definitely be able to work. Enzo one side, Caicedo the other. And Lavia somewhere in between, somewhere in the middle. So we'll see, though. We'll see what happens. But we don't know when he's coming back. Would you do a Twitter space discussion? No, not really. I talk too much, basically. You know, if I do that and YouTube, I don't even do my Twitch, and that's been neglected for about a year, and DR and Big Six, and it's just too much talking. I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it. There's other people doing it. I'm not as active on Twitter as others. You know, there's other massive accounts on there that will run spaces because they don't have YouTube. So it just makes sense to just, you know, just if anything, I'll listen. I'll rather listen than talk because I talk enough. So yeah, not for me. Let's see. How does Enzo and Caicedo play good for their nations and just forget everything in Chelsea? This is the question that's been haunting this club for many years. I mean, how many times do we see players before they arrive balling out, they come here, they die, and it happens in rotation. It's a cycle, you know, it's a severe, vicious cycle. Hopefully it ends. But the way that ends is with stability, with continuity, with consistency with the manager, and from top to bottom, having a clear ethos in terms of approach, style of play. What do you want your culture and your club to look like? And we have never had this in recent years. We knew what it was previously under Roman. It wasn't what, you know, teams thrive off now, which is stability, but we were doing our own thing in our own special way. Since this ownership come in, it's just been kamikaze, right? You know, they come in, they get rid of everyone, fine. Petacek really probably should have stayed. It's all in hindsight, but Petacek was not so linked to Roman like Marina was at all that he couldn't have stayed and been with Tuchel in that window and bridged the gap between Tuchel and the board and, you know, cut out the WhatsApp messages. That's a big L. And then not bringing in a director of football before hiring Potter is also another L in hindsight, right? If you do it, if you know this before, then you should probably work for the club. Do you know what I mean? Fair play to you. At that time, I wasn't thinking about it like that, but I didn't even want Tuchel to be sacked in the first place. But in terms of hiring a manager as ownership that are fresh into the sport, you just didn't have the credentials and the knowledge to be making that decision. You just don't. Sporting directors are there. They get paid big bucks for a reason. Their job is vast. Like, the knowledge in their brain is of another level, right? They're meant to be the leaders of clubs in terms of footballing activity, right? Everything from the coach to the style to the profile of players, the character, everything. When you look at Liverpool, as much as Klopp gets his credit, Edwards is just as important as Klopp in this. Tiki to Pep, right? These people shape clubs. If you don't have someone to do that, you end up in the mess we're in, which is nobody knows what the hell's going on. Nobody knows who they should, nobody knows what the vision is or what we're striving to do or what we're actually basing our method on. They should have brought him in. They should have brought that guy in before they hired Potter. And that guy should have decided who should have come in next. That guy, if Tuchel had to leave, they should have said, okay, but we don't know who to hire because we can't just look at Brighton and say, oh, we like them, or Leipzig, we like them. We need to actually know who to bring in. So we need to bring in someone who knows football. And that's the problem. And then ever since then, it's all gone tits up. So yeah, it's a long day. Penalties now. When are we kicking off? We're kicking off in about 20 something minutes. You really think we'll win this game? Okay, fair enough. He's probably the first person to say that, because there's not many people that think we're going to win this game, if any. I mean, you are now one. I've counted one. I mean, to be fair, the poll says that there are people that believe that we're going to win. Fair play. But yeah, I think if Lavia was in that midfield, I think Caicedo would play even better. I do. Because I know Lavia would be next to him, you know. You can't even try to put Lavia in the 10. Don't even think about it. Enzo, there's a little bit of a temptation to do it because his final ball is probably better than, you know, it is better than Gallagher's, in my opinion, in terms of his pass. So the temptation is to maybe push him up closer to the forward to play those killer passes or whatever the vision is, right? I don't know. But Lavia, you ain't gonna put him anywhere other than next to Caicedo. You're really not. It's impossible. So yeah, it would have just been one person less to miss profile if he was in the squad. You can't miss profile him. It's very clear. He plays in that first phase. There is no other position for him. let's see. Chilwell, yeah, we mentioned Badia Shield. Chilwell's got a big game. It's been a very, very rough week for him as captain. He hasn't been captain much this season because it's either been James and he was injured and it was Gallagher for a large spell. He's not really been captain much, but as a captain's week can go, it's gone as bad as it can go for him, because not only has he played poorly in both games and we've been absolutely cut up on his side by either Bradley or Neto or whoever it may be, but he's also left the young boy in the Liverpool game to stand there on his own when he's really the one in charge of sorting that situation out as captain. And then damage limitation or damage control had to be done on his post-match quotes, which we heard what we heard. So it wasn't even that deep. I mean, it is that deep, but, you know, I've heard players say it a million times. It was just one of those press conference or interviews that you could tell it wasn't really the most authentic. It was just a very much robotic, media-trained post-match, not really very emotional one, which is not what you want from a captain, which is why I say you shouldn't be captain. It's just not been a good week. So he needs a big performance. He needs to kind of rise to the level and lock up someone in that wide position. Bailey, Diaby, you know what I mean? He needs to lock someone up. So we'll see how he does today. His stocks are dropping at the moment. He needs to respond. And he's captain. You are captain of the club. Imagine. It might be scary. I'm scared for you too, because I don't think you're ready. But you are captain of the club. You're captain of this team. When Reece James isn't. So you got to show that leadership. You've got to show that leadership. at least you've got to do your job. You know, a captain is meant to do their job and propel and improve others around them. You're not even doing your job. So it's a long day, but you got to at least do your job today. Forget about motivating others. You got to at least perform your own role. Let's see. Little pun there, yeah? Man's got puns, yeah? Is that what you're doing? Let's see. What other games are going on today? I'm guessing most teams didn't have to do a replay and they just handled their business. I'm seeing Astrid Wet has found out she's 19% Nigerian. Thanks for letting me know that in the Big Six chat. She's getting cooked. The Nigerians are not happy. Oh, I've muted this account. No offense, obviously. But it's just like, it's just people will still find a way to alert you of what is going on, regardless of whether you ask for it or not. Fucking hell, bruv. Now my day's really ruined. Oh, Lord. Oh, God damn. That's what I'm saying. If they is it penalties now, right? So if they lose, bro, it's just gonna be a jinx, really. That's just how they're gonna see it. The Nigerians are going, they're going in, they're cooking. They're cooking, man. All right, let me see. So let me actually see if I can get it up. So this penalties, let me see if I can find this channel now. Oh, god damn. Where is this? Why are they showing the cricket? Are they taking a mick? South Africa playing the cricket or something? Oh, cut. Super Sport, don't be silly. Don't be silly. You must show the game. Oh, crazy. This is beyond tapped. Romania versus bruv. What is going on? Honestly. All right. I'll see if I can find it. Yeah, he's in. Kante's in. He's in Saudi. Okay. ITV1 will. AFCON, the final is everything not being shown on Sky Sports, isn't it? Yeah. So what am I doing? It better be on Sky Sports. I think all the AFCON's meant to be being shown on Sky Sports. I don't know if the final's going to be on what channels. But yeah, I'm just watching this penalty shootout now. I've got it up on screen. I forgot it was on Sky Sports. I forgot. It's on BBC too. All right, BBC. Cool. So let's just see. Let's just see how these penalties play out before we go back to Chelsea. I don't even know what the score is on penalties. I'm waiting to see if they got a graphic. What a save. I don't know if I'm ahead or behind. Probably behind. Raw, Nigeria. What a save for the penalty spot. Raw. Who's leading this shootout, guys? Who's leading the shootout? Looks like South Africa in a bit of bother after that one. It's a big save. Nigeria. I can't believe Osimhen is not one of these takers. Nigeria are going to win. Oh, this will be 2-0. This is our former, the former centre-back from the Chelsea Academy is the one that scored that penalty there. And he did it very calmly as well. Walked it into the bottom corner. He used to play for us. And I think he went out on loan to Middlesbrough as well. He's taken that very well. He's taken that very well. Right, he took that penalty like a G, you know. Fair play, he took that like a G. And Oh, so Ivory Coast are later on. Okay. So that's not even, that's not done yet. Oh. That's not him. Oh, is it not? What? Same last name, different person. Oh, okay. Are you sure? Fair enough. Oh, that's only just gone in. That's only, that penalty there was close to being saved as well. South Africa under pressure. I'm guessing that's their first spot kick gone in, and that's the third one taken to make it 2-1 to Nigeria. But Nigeria got now a penalty to take. Oh, no. Former Chelsea blood in trouble. Ola Aina. I'm about to see it. Oh, my day. Yes, so it's 2-1 on the penalties, but now our madness is about to take place. I'm just seeing this Ola Aina penalty now. Oh, God. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Nigerian hearts just broke. Oh, my days. That was bad. Because you know if he scores that, you lot are through. They're not coming back after that. They're really not coming back after that. You've let them back in now. 3-1 is finished. 3-1 is finished. You got two bites at the cherry after that. It's very, very unlikely you're not gonna take one of them. That is not good. South Africa, yeah? Oh my days. What's going on here? I know Thabz is watching this and so stressed. Hey. South Africa with the penalties. What's going on today with the penalties for South Africa? They're so unreliable right now. They're not striking them very well. Even the one before this nearly got saved. And then people are saying that this one... Oh, that is shocking. You can't take a penalty like that, man. No power behind it. No conviction. No placement. Oh, my days. What a poor penalty, man. You, man, deserve to go home. I can't lie. After watching that penalty. No, that's awful. And it's telegraphed as well. It's so obvious where he was going. Oh, my days. Didn't even try and make him second guess. And he's wearing the number 9 shirt. So that means he's a striker. Oh, my days. Oh, my days. Yeah, you man are going home, I'm afraid. Because there's no way Nigeria are going to let you off. There's no way they're going to let you off again. You man are going home. You man are going home. Taking penalties like that, you're going home. You're going home, bro. It's only a matter of time because that is insane. Can't believe that. So I'm guessing this is going to make it 3-1. I can't envision him missing. Nigeria again. Yeah, brilliant penalty. That's how a penalty is taken. That's how you take a penalty. Power, precise. That's how you take a penalty. Top corner. You're not saving that. That ball went past him before he even saw it. Yeah, man, you're not saving those penalties, bro. You see how quick that ball just traveled. Yeah, you're not saving that. It's my birthday today. Hopefully we win. Oh, brother. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Listen, I apologize in advance. I apologize in advance, all right? I hope you're not counting on Chelsea. I know you are, but hopefully you've had a great day before that, before the game, and after the game you continue to, because what happens in this period, yeah, we don't know. We don't know about all that, bro.
Oh, dear.
South Africa scored their penalty, so it's 3-2. So if Nigeria score the next one, then they're going through. Then they're through to the final of the AFCON. And they will play either Ivory Coast or Congo. And that game gets decided tonight. Part of me just wants it to be Ivory Coast because obviously then it's an absolute Royal Rumble in terms of there's two sets of supporters. And obviously, yeah, there's many legends in attendance as well. So that's going to be good. Mikel versus Drogba. Ian Nacho. Again, he doesn't actually start consistently for Leicester, which is crazy to me in the Championship. But I'm assuming, again, he's going to score and put Nigeria through. And he does. And it's a brilliant penalty. Nigeria gone through to the final. Job done. And they probably are... Well, I mean, Ivory Coast are in... You know, it's in their nation. It's in their country. So they maybe have home advantage. That maybe... I don't know if that makes them favourites or not, but... It's going to be a great game if they get through. Nigeria go through. And it wasn't easy, clearly. You know, it's gone to penalties, but they're through. Nigeria are going to be moving mad on Twitter. You better watch out. If you're Ghanaian, I suggest that you just don't even go on Twitter, to be honest, tonight. I suggest that you just evacuate and don't even go over there because you don't want to see that. You really don't want to see that. Yeah, you man should just pack it in for the day. It's best that you pack it in. Oh, dear. All right. Well, we are kicking off in 9 minutes, thankfully, because I really, you know, the longer I wait for us to kick off, is more nervous I'm going to get. So really, it's time to kick off now. Enough of the foolishness. Enough of the shenanigans. We've spoken on everything. I think Badiashile, Chilwell, those are the two that really need big games the most. Everybody does, but those two are under some serious... And to be honest, Caicedo and Enzo as well, they need big games, obviously. They always do, really. I kind of just put them down as default because of the money they cost. Everybody's always watching them. So let's see. Where is this now? Big game. Starting to get a little bit nervous now. Saeed's calling. All right, let me go on Discord then, and I'll chat to him for about 5 minutes before we kick off. What is he doing? Watch along. I didn't know it was. 1 second. Okay. Can you hear me? I don't think he can. Let me give him another ring. It's a proper ring. Yeah. Okay, cool.
Oh, brother Matisse.
Brother Saeed.
Are you telling me?
Are you doing a watch along for this?
No, I'm actually not doing... I'm not focusing on your game. Watch along. We're not focusing on your game.
Oh,
well, we are doing what? Focusing, though. It's not a hate along. It's not, you know, it's not nothing. We're just, you know, I call it today a mega watch along.
Rebranding, yeah? You're rebranding.
I'm rebranding, bro.
And if something were to happen at Villa Park that would go against us in some type of way, you wouldn't go and change the title now, would you?
No. The title's not changing because I'm going to be live after this. After your game, I'll probably finish the Atletico Madrid game as well. So I won't be, it's not a hate along. It's not, no, you know, we're just here with scouting as well because we've got Villa on the weekend as well. So.
Bro, listen, I did the same when you played Wolves. I had a little bit of scouting as well. I did a little bit of scouting. What's going on with your internet, bro?
Hey,
you're really choppy today. What's going on with your internet?
My internet's choppy.
Yeah, bro.
Is that a Chelsea effect?
Yeah, Gordon Ramsay said, bro, you man's in the kitchen too much. Very choppy, bro.
Oh, is it choppy?
Yeah, bro.
Let me analyze what's going on here.
Analyze
what's going on.
Oh dear.
Let me just do some analysis.
It's funny because I scouted the Wolves Man United game and then we got battered by Wolves. So obviously I didn't understand enough of what happened. You know, clearly.
Bro. I don't know for you today, you know. I really don't know for you today, bro, you know. Like,
I think we do know. I think we do know. This is not a good situation.
No, I'm stuck in two minds. If you lose this game, I believe Pochettino gets sacked. I think this is a game
really
where he gets sacked after this game.
Wow.
Yeah. I generally think for me, this is one of them where he loses this game. Carabao Cup, yeah, it's something, it's a final, but this is one of them where it could be more humiliation.
It's a big game, bro. But big game. We're only in,
it is.
We can only go anywhere in two cups. This is one of them. And Liverpool in the final is not good.
This is one of them.
It's difficult. So.
No, it's not good. You know what I mean? There's more chance of you winning the FA Cup than that game. You know what I'm saying? Let's be real, man. You know what I mean? Because you can get different people in the FA Cup. But I don't know. But then I'm like, you know what? I want the band to continue. Like the Chelsea.
It's not even funny anymore.
That's saving YouTube right now.
It's not even funny anymore. Come on now. It's not funny anymore. Come
you know
on.
What? I'm not going to lie to you. It's not funny. It's not funny.
It's not. Even you, man, in the Big Six group chat, you ain't even say anything last time we lost. You just said nothing.
Yeah, I know. I know. Because we're like, you know what, man? Where can we go from, man? Because you know what it is, yeah? It's the fact that Chelsea fans, yeah, especially under Pochettino, like you haven't been talking the wildest talk about your manager.
No. Do you know what? Like,
because you know as well.
Yeah, go on.
Yeah. Yeah, no, go on.
I was just about to say, as you said that, I was scrolling through my Twitter from now till August, back in August. And I haven't really done any propaganda for the manager at all. Like, obviously, everybody knows I wanted him.
No, you haven't.
Everybody knows I wanted him. But, like, I have not put up many propaganda tweets for the manager or much, like... I've not done any.
No,
like,
you haven't.
It's mad. Like, no one's really been doing too much prop. It's peak.
It's crazy, bro. And that's why I'm like, you know what? Fair play to you. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's one of them where I'm like, I'll give it to Matisse. But still, man, I'm not gonna lie to you. I've got a feeling you're gonna win tonight, you know. I feel like you're gonna win tonight.
Are you jinxing this
Villa
game?
Villa are good, yeah. No. I think you're gonna win tonight.
Why?
I've got faith in you.
Why do you think that?
Yeah, I've got faith in you.
Oh, no.
I just don't know. Cup competitions, you're a bit of side distraction. This year, you've done well in the cups. So I feel like this is your kind of like, you know, like the Mourinho effect where he just went in the cups. You know, I feel like this is your kind of moment now. Every time they have a bad Premier League display, they always do well in the cups. So this is a bit of a Chelsea kind of distraction, you know? That's the way I kind of look at it.
I don't know about that now. I don't know if we're... I've watched us in the cups against Blackburn, Wimbledon. We weren't great. So I'm not sure. But we'll see.
I don't know, man. You know what I'm saying? But we will be there, man. Yeah. We will be there. Someone say, look at tweet about Fab. What's he done, Fab? Fabrizio Romano now? Is he just baiting stuff? Oh, man. Yeah, Fabrizio Romano. Yeah, he definitely dropped him because of the Bella situation. But then again, he's 39 anyway. He can't play back-to-back
games. This was quite 39, funny. Man. This was quite funny because when I seen this initially on the team sheet, obviously, I knew everybody would think that. But it is a cup game, and obviously he's 39, so he can't play three times a week. So I think he might have already been coming out of the team anyway. But because of what happened, it's just obviously the irony is like, it's just crazy, isn't it? Like that he gets dropped after that. So, but you know, I said on Twitter, like, even if you think she's spitting or she's, you know, she's spitting facts, you can't run a club where family members and
You can't.
People are talking about freedom of speech. Like,
I agree.
I'm sorry. It doesn't matter what company it is or any institution of this magnitude in any sport. Like, some people do have to keep their mouth shut. That's just how it is. Like, that's life. Yeah. You can't just talk anyway. You are the wife of one of the players who have to train under the manager that you potentially want to have sacked. That just doesn't work. You know what I mean? You're not a normal fan. No. People are like, oh, she goes to the games. I'm like, yeah, that's great. But she's not a normal fan. She's Thiago Silva's wife. You are not Thiago Silva's wife. You are Kent from Surrey.
You know what?
Do you know what I mean?
If you watch, have you watched a Netflix documentary, the World Cup one?
Have I? I don't think I have, you know.
Yeah, watch her in that one as well. She's very, very proper, I love her.
She's very outspoken. She's very humble. She gets along with the fans great. She's always with the fans. Like, she's not doing all this prestige thing. She's amongst it. I get it. So what happened was she probably lost her head. she probably lost her head and just thought she could move mad. But obviously, with the tweet that she put out today, it's obvious that Thiago Silva had a word with Poch. The club had a word and they said, listen, bro, she needs to pass.
Yes.
She needs to pass.
It's
clear.
I see that.
People are saying it's not a retraction. Yeah. Just because she didn't apologize, or no, she did apologize. Just because she didn't take it back and say, oh, I was wrong, it doesn't mean it's not a retraction. She's trying to say, listen, yeah, I can't say what I said, but you heard what I said, innit? Do you know what I mean?
You heard what I said, but I can't yes. elaborate on it more. And you know I'm gonna keep it as that, basically. No, I rate that, man. Don't take it back, but just say, you know what? Okay, cool. I'm gonna leave it there. You know what I'm saying?
I'm so now.
No, I hear that, man.
But you can't. But you know what? Do you know what it is, bro? Man, do you know what it is, bro? You like we can't. You can't have that running because, like, if you let her do it. Then what's to stop Mudrik's dad from saying something or Enzo's dad or, you know what I mean, someone's... Do you know what I mean? You can't just let everybody have a free-for-all on the manager just because you don't rate the manager. Like, that's just not proper, bro. That's not professional. Yeah. There's channels for this. Facts, there's ways facts, of doing facts. These things, man. So, yeah.
Facts. Yeah, man. But anyway. Yeah, we'll carry on this watchdog together. What do you think of the game then, Matisse?
No.
Should we do this together? Yeah.
No. We have rules. We have rules around here. When we're doing rivals, we have rules.
When Man United, I tried it.
Goodbye.
big up, man. Matisse, big up, man. All right, good luck.
Yeah, I'm going to need it. Oh, dear. You tried it, though. All right, we're about to kick off. We just kicked off. Time is going to be on screen. Man tried to stick around. No. Bye-bye. We don't do that. Right, so we're kicking off. Oh, funny. Yeah, listen, bro. Listen, people will talk about, like, I'm all for, you know, freedom of speech, but working environments have rules and working environments have like unwritten rules too. Just because she doesn't have a contract with Chelsea, it doesn't mean that she can say anything because she's directly linked to Chelsea and she is in the inner circle. I call it the bubble. Just like same way on the flip side. Oh, Aston Villa coming forward. Oh my God, are we going to concede already? Just on the flip side, you have Caicedo and... Perez's family members in Ecuador. There was some sort of dispute going on in Ecuador. I don't know the details, but Chelsea sent security to look after those family members because they are an extension of the player that they have signed. Chelsea have a contract with the players, but it is right and proper that they look after the people around the players too. But that also extends to social media, and you know, you gotta act right. So you don't have to like it. I'm not saying that I don't agree with her. I clearly do, but that's not for her to be putting out there. It's for the fans or the journalists or whatever. But everybody's got to play their role, bro. You can't play as a striker when you're a centre back. It's just that simple, you know. And if you don't like it, then you have to take it up with the world because every football club would run like that. There's no football club that would allow parents of players or you know, wives of players or presenters that work at the club to say stuff like that. Anybody that presents for the club and works for the club, they don't cuss out or say stuff like that about the club online. So, it's, you know, there's rules to the game, bro. Aston Villa coming forward. It works like that with any company, though. Oh, my God. Why are we so... Brother, it's been 2 minutes, and I'm telling you now, the ball is just entering parts of the box that it should never be in. Like, 2 minutes and this team have allowed the ball to be in areas that I just don't understand how it's made it there. I don't even understand how the ball has been allowed to travel into these areas. What's going on? What is actually going on? Like it's almost like this is a 12:30 kickoff and we just haven't woken up yet. It's mad. All right, they've played out a play now. Let's see if we can get our foot on the ball for 3 minutes and behave ourselves because I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on. Was he onside? It's just mad that there's nobody at the back post tracking that person. He's just on his own. It's been crossed to him. He's on his... Look, bruv. He's on his own and there's just nobody there. He's... Free diving header to put it back across the box. Gusto's awareness right back on that side. What's going on? What's going on? Absolutely mad. All right, cool. So that's what we're doing now. We're on the game. Everything's cool. I'm going to get up on a second screen in a minute. just to cover myself. Here's Chilwell, Caicedo coming through now. Enzo. Now Jackson. Jackson on the left-hand side. Maybe we're going to see like Jackson and... Yeah, I don't know. Because Jackson's pulled out to the left in that phase of play. But Palmer's not over there. So it's, yeah, I don't know. We're going to find out how this is all going to work. Big up everybody in the building. It's Villa Park. They are one of the most informed home teams in the country over the last year. In 2023, one of the best home teams. So I'm not expecting us to be comfortable early stages. You know, we got to get through this early period and settle ourselves down, potentially. We might be a bag of nerves. But at some point, you'd like to hope that we'd be able to put our foot on the ball, because right now it's been very disjointed. We're just kind of just fighting for our lives at this point. See how the referee... Who's refereeing this game? He seems to have many hair follicles, so it looks... Oi, Caicedo! Nice turn, brother. Nice turn. Nice turn. Madueke right side. Let's go. See, this is my problem. No aerial threat. Palmer! Got a little toe to it. Every single ball into the box has got to be a cutback today or a very precise pass, because we know aerially that Jackson's not going to be on anything. Same with Palmer, so... Madueke's pass selection and decision-making has to be on point. If we're going to get the ball out to him, that's all well and good, but you need to really have your head up. Don't even think for a second you can just spam anything in there. Here's De Sassi. Well done. Play it. Nice. Caicedo, wonderful. Madueke, let's play it. Let's keep the ball. Let's see five passes string together. Wow. Honestly, I ask for so little. Man just wants five passes. There we go. There we go. Enzo. Yeah. Yes. Enzo, switch of play. Come on. I might start celebrating things like that, you know. I might take the piss today. I'm telling you. I'm in a very jokey mood. I might just take the piss today and start celebrating other things. I don't necessarily need goals. Caicedo, switch of play. Whoa. I'm dead ass. I might start celebrating other things. Goals, the game's not all about goals. Goals are overhyped. People talk about goals all the time. It's just goal. It's not about goals. It's not always about goals. Goals is like 1% of any 90-minute game. Even in a 4-4. What about the other 89 minutes? You know what I mean? What about the switches of play? And the passes. Yeah, that's what we're going to be on today. Chilwell's going to get the cross in now. If this gets completed and someone gets their head on it, that's 1-0. Ball comes into the box. Someone get your head. Get your noggin on it. Ah. Again, go on. Ah! Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Is he onside? Oh, my days. How have you not scored that? How have you not scored that? Are you shitting me? Oh, my. Oh, no. Do you know what? I think they got in each other's way. They got in each other's way. I think Enzo ended up heading it, but I think it was Badia Shield that was in front of him. Yo, was he off? Okay, if he was off, then fair enough. I didn't see the flag go up. That was a chance. That was a chance. Because you know, sometimes you can get those moments where you head it back in and someone's not with the rest of their line in the Villa side and they've just strayed behind and left everybody on side for a tap-in. That could have been a moment. Need this win, man. All I've got is the cups. The league is looking peak. So all I've got is the cups. That's it. We need to win this game. Here's, all right. Aston Villa back in possession now. Playing it around. Oh, shit. How did that get through? Gusto, get back. Good tackle. Good tackle. All right, Villa down this left. Win it. Nice. Play it. Caicedo. Well done. Good start to this game from Caicedo. Good awareness. Let's keep that up. Don't want to see no turnovers in that midfield today. Enzo, so far, has been in nice positions in build-up. So that's good. He's not playing in stupid positions. Looks like a 4-3-3 with Gallagher and Enzo. Enzo really should sometimes be next to Caicedo and then win the ball high up the pitch, a little bit higher, potentially on the edge of the area for the goal or for the assist, you know? But the build-up now, you see Badiashil just pass that to Enzo. That's what I want. That's what I ask for. And look how nice we've managed to come through now, the pitch. Play it. Nice. There we go. And be patient, you know? Be patient, fam. You don't need to rush. I wouldn't mind a bit of patience right now. A little bit of possession. It's not a problem. Bop the ball around. Everybody get some touches. Get some confidence. Make Villa run around a bit. Tire them out. You don't need to play 100 miles per hour. Look, Enzo coming. There we go. Enzo coming to the ball. That's what we want. Gallagher, you don't have to come to the ball like that, really. Nice. Oh, Jackson. Intercept. Nice. Nice. Chilwell. Gallagher, play it. Yes. Come on, Jackson. He's not really got many options. What are you going to do? Okay, cut back. Okay. Okay, somebody get a shot off. Oh! Yes! 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 Are you dumb? Come on! Yes! Yes! Come on! Come on! Come on! Yes! Oh my days, what a finish! What a finish! Yo, was that Gallagher, yeah? I've been waiting on a goal like that all season, brother. Man's been waiting on a miracle like Sean. Come on! What a finish! What a finish! That's what we've been expecting. Bringing back some Crystal Palace goals or something. Finish! Finish! And he's had to do that because, myself included, we didn't really want you in the 11, brother. You know what I mean? We were looking at Carney for this one. So you needed to do something. What a finish, man. Yes. And that all comes from having a bit of possession, people in build-up play that should be there, and just taking some time on the football, bruv. Instead of just moving like absolute twats. Bruh, I've taken so much pleasure from that goal, honestly. Don't go and ruin it now like against Wolves where you just concede about 2 minutes later. Get back. Oh my days, we're going to concede, aren't we? Jesus. Oh my God. Get the ball clear. My heavens. You man really just want me to have a heart attack, innit? That's what it is. Just say you want me dead. Just say you want me dead. Oh my days. It felt very similar to Wolves because that shot looked like it was going to get deflected and Petrovic would be nowhere near it. Nothing he could do about it. And we just took so long to get it clear. Look, again, defending. Wow, Petrovic save. Rotted. Oh my days. We need to chill, man. Oi, we need to chill. Watkins testing Petrovic with the shot. We need to chill. Bro, what's going on? McGinn with the corner. Oh, geez. Clear, clear, clear. Okay, good. Gusto. Is this Gusto coming forward? Yo. Yo, what's going on? Jackson. Gusto. Okay. Oh, fucking hell, Gusto, mate. Come on. Oh, Gusto, man. Take your time. He was never really right in that counter. He left the ball behind. Jackson had to come get it. And then on that play there, just don't know what he's doing. He slipped as he's passed it. All right. Villa back in possession. come on. 13 minutes, 40 seconds. Aston Villa in possession. Keep, in terms of on the ball, keep doing what you just did. Off the ball, yeah, these chances that we're conceding, I prefer not to speak. I don't know what we're going to do about that. I like our off the ball shape right now. It's looking good. You can see they got a plan to press. I like it. They got a plan to press. They didn't get the ball. They had to make a foul in the end, but I saw the vision. Gallagher there on the keeper. There's a lot of energy in this team with Palmer up there, Gallagher, Madueke. You should be having plenty of energy in them. In those young, come on, he's a young player. There's no reason for no energy. Like, there's no reason. There's no Sterling, who's had his, you know, work rate questioned. So there's just no excuse today for not cutting out the passing lanes and pressing properly. Come on, there's no Silver as well. So. Obviously, we know we have to look after him a little bit on the age thing. So, should be a very energetic performance. At the very least, it should be a very energetic performance. I'm not expecting no bullshit on that side. Chilwell's going to take the throw. Come on, guys. Nice. Gallagher, Enzo, go on. He's not really got options. Left side. Oh, brilliant. A brilliant pass, Enzo. Go on. Oh, unlucky. Okay, go on, play it. Palmer again. Palmer. Yep. Oh, dilly-dally a bit too much. There we go. Yeah, just play it. Just play the ball. Referee, thank you very much. Free kick. Chilwell, left side. Good. Jackson. Look much better than with him up top, man. Ah, oh, didn't connect. Look much better with him back up top. He's mobile. He's linking things up. Just making the whole attack look a lot better in general. The finishing, that's a different question. But in terms of just the way that we knit the attacks up, and actually, because some of the turnovers in the Liverpool game, we could not knit anything together in attack. Just turnover after turnover after turnover. It was insane. So bad. It's good defending, Chilwell. The Sassy clips it over the top. Madueke. Get in. All right. Our shape off the balls are looking a bit better now. It's Enzo and Caicedo just in front of the defence. There we go. Starting to win the ball in good areas now. Let's play it. There we go. Listen, come on. Let's try and get the second. Madueke right side. Do something. Finish. Oh, is that defense? That has to be deflected, Madueke. That's real wide, man. That's really far wide. Surely that's been deflected. Starting to win the ball in good areas now. Settled ourselves down a bit. That surely has to have taken the deflection. It was so wide. He's not wrapped his foot around that at all. Oh, my days. Enzo, I think Enzo was screaming at him there not to play the pass. It's good play. It's good play. Win the ball in good areas. Off the ball, we look a bit better. People are taking up good positions. I'm not seeing Caicedo left alone to die today, which is nice. Oh, Caicedo, just keep it. Oh, brilliant! Caicedo and Enzo, that's what I want. Close together. Close together. Passes like that. That's how you get through. Don't leave my man on his own. That's what I'm talking about. That partnership, I'm telling you, it must work by force. It must work by force. They speak the same language. I'm not having no excuse. Caicedo, play it. There we go. Over the top. Madueke, bring it down. Nice. What you got? Nice ball. We ain't got no threat like that. Caicedo, bring it down. Gala got to play it. Come on. There we go. Look good, man. Look much better. Starting to improve as the game goes on, as opposed to the first 10 minutes. Just need to keep plugging away with these passes. This is how we should be playing. Enzo, lovely, lovely pass. That's what I fucking want to see. This is why I scream about this guy being in deep positions. This is why I scream about it. Go on, gusto. Ball in. Jackson! Ah! Oh, he scored a header! He scored a header! It's 2-0! It's 2! Are you mad? What's happening? What is going on at Villa Park? Oh my God! What is going on? What is going on, Saeed? Saeed had a good feeling. I told him, shut up your mouth. What is going on? Oh my God, when Jackson scores a header, you know that something is going on. Something scary. What? Accuracy in the cross. And this is why I celebrate Enzo switches of play. I don't need this guy to be stacking up on GA. You just have to watch. You just have to be watching. These are the positions that I want him to play in. I just want him to be on the ball, making those passes. And then we just look better. We just function better. We get into better positions. Everybody today so far is just playing in positions that make sense. This is better. This is much better, man. We don't need that GA. Just play the game properly, man. Just play the game properly. Yeah, that's insane. I'm chuffed. Let's keep this up. Caicedo and Enzo in that midfield is just much better today to watch, man. Gallagher, he's done brilliantly. He's winning the ball in good areas. Scored a great goal. This is good. So if we just tighten up on not letting any big chances go the other way, deal with them crosses a bit better, then we might be able to actually get through this game. I don't know. Enzo again, switching it right side. That's, see what I'm talking about? Do you see what I'm talking about? Oh, gusto, you got to do better. You got to do better. But do you see what I'm talking about? Enzo Fernandez. Yes. Oh, unfortunate. Yes. This is what I'm talking about. These are the positions that we pay for. These are the positions that we pay for. Fuck. Come on. Bruv, it's actually a joy to watch us right now. I actually enjoy watching us on the ball. It's crazy. Can't wait until we get it next. Just keep playing like this, man. Goddamn, I can't wait till we get possession again. I can't wait. That's how it is. It's just mad. Jackson's definitely off the left. Oh, I don't like that gap. You better get back and deal with that. I don't like that gap. Got to be watching Watkins. Look, these crosses. We're not dealing with these guys. That's the one problem. That's the one big problem so far today. These crosses coming into the box, people are free in the box. People are free, man. We're not dealing with these crosses properly. There's too many people in way too much space over there. I don't know what's going on with these crosses. Look. Bro, look. Bro, the gap is right there behind you, man. Wake up. You're ball watching. Yes, you put your hand. You're ball watching, bro. Come on. You're ball watching. Yeah, look, that's a striker defending right there. Or somebody is not playing the offside trap right. I don't know. Is that offside in the end? Yeah, you can't ball watch, bro. If you've got to track back on that fullback cash, you've got to stay switched on, man. Got lucky, man. Come on. Thankful that line was just about offside because, we was a bit lucky. Oh, go on, oh shit, good defending. Chilwell's been better today, been better so far today. Palmer, let's give him options, please. Let's give him options. Someone, anyone. He's won the free kick, well done. This is much better today. I just hope it carries on. I just want this to be consistent just for today, at least. Just give us today. I've had a good day. It's our brother's birthday in the chat. He said earlier, let's just have a good day. Let's not think about tomorrow. Let's just make sure this performance stays throughout the match. That's all I ask for. Because I don't want this first 25 minutes to be forgotten about because we do some foolishness later. Keep the ball. There we go. Lovely way to pass. Enzo again in a nice position. Enzo fogging Fernandez. That's what we love. Jackson, left side. Goal kick. Yeah, this is definitely a one-night stand situation. Hey, I'm telling you, bruv. Just enjoy the night, innit? That's what this is. Like, we don't really know you. We don't really know what your intentions are. We don't know who you're friends with. But we're having a good time. We're having a good time. Let's just enjoy the day. Let's just enjoy the night. Let's not think too much. That's what this is, bro. That's what this is. I'm telling you. Because this ain't come out of nowhere. I ain't seen a performance like in terms of the way we are on the ball like this in months. I can't remember the last time we played on the ball like this, where I saw Enzo Fernandez actually on the ball with Caicedo. And I'm talking about against good opposition because I ain't going to bring up the Middlesbrough game. So, yeah, long may this continue in the match, man. Look how much better Caicedo is now that he's got someone next to him. He's not on his own with midfielders running away from him. Imagine. How many weeks have I been asking for Enzo Fernandez to not be running away from the build-up? Do you know how stupid that is? The defenders have the ball, and I've seen Enzo Fernandez this season running away from them. Running behind players. Come on, man. Get this brother on the ball. Get these midfielders midfielding, man. Unlucky. Get that ball back. Come on. I really, really hope we keep this going, man. I'm nervous now because we've started so well, but it won't mean anything if we bottle it. We need to see this through. There's so much time left. We just got to try and get another goal. Just got to keep playing the way we've played. Chilwell. There's nobody there, guys. You got to get in the box, man. Come on, you got to get in the box, man. Can't have the left back over there and there's nobody in the box. It's crazy. Go on. Yep, send them wide. There we go. Well done. Baited them in. Brilliant. Caicedo, turn. Go on. Petrovic. Caicedo. Lovely. Madueke. Right side. Is that a corner ref? Yeah. Good. Lads, 3-0. Go and get the third goal. Like, there's absolutely no reason to be thinking of anything other than let's try and get the third goal. Like, we ain't in no position to be comfortable about nothing. Let's just go and get the third goal. Let's just try and get as many goals as possible to make up for any madness that might happen. Like, let's just put the biggest buffer in between us and Villa as we can while we're playing well. That's how I see it, man. Just get that third goal. Let's take advantage. There's no reason to put the... Yeah, I'm not calling my nothing, bruv. I want the third goal, bruv. Let's go. Ain't no time like the present. Put that ball in the box. Go on. Cause I know we're capable of conceding 3 goals. So let's get that third goal. Win the tackle. Yes, Gallagher. Let's go again. Come on. Corner again. Let's go. Corner again. Come on. Let's go. If we carry this on, and I see this midfield playing any other way again, I swear to God, I'll lose my head. You just are getting the ultimate template of how this midfield should be structured and how it should be operating. I swear if I don't see this after this, if we go back to the foolishness, I will lose my head, man. It's plain and obvious, plain in sight. This is how our midfield has to be operating. This is how we, you know, whether it's Gallagher or Carney or whatever, forget that. But in terms of Enzo and Caicedo, this is how this midfield is meant to be operating and looking. If I see anything other than that, bruv, I swear, after getting the template in front of your eyes, if I see Enzo making runs in behind the striker again, I swear, I'll break this whole TV. I'll lose it. My heart can't take it, bruv. It's just so obvious. This is the position he played at Benfica. This is the position he plays for Argentina. He always plays this deep. He ain't playing no 10. Maybe since River Plate, I don't know, but I don't know what them be doing in South America. Them games are on past my bedtime. Go on. Baddie Ashil. Oh, my days. Baddie Ashil, wake up, man. That was a hospital pass. Hospital pass. Yeah, 2-0 is dangerous, man. I ain't playing with no 2-0 score. I want a third goal. You ain't never going to be able to take the proper Chelsea out of me, bruv. I remember them Carlo Ancelotti days, bruv, when we slapped up Villa 8-0. Go and get me that second goal, bruv. Go and get me that third goal, bruv. In the name of Carlo Ancelotti, Didier Drogba, Solomon Kalou, and Florent Malouda, bruv. Go and get me that third goal. Don't rest. Let's get this Barclays going back how it should be. That's Barclays heritage right there. Gone. Play down the side. Oh, my days. This is so shameless. Nah, mate. Because you see me, yeah? Even though I've said what I've said, you're never going to get me, like, praying on his downfall or anything. You're never going to get me, like, saying, oh, I hope he fails, or I hope, like, you're never going to get that. So, if anything, he should apologize to me. Because I'm the one that backed his ass and then he made me look like an idiot, bruv. So he can apologize to me. Now he's using Enzo correctly, bruv. You can apologize to me. I can't lie. I'll get that video done, though. Do a little sit-down interview and he can explain to me, bruv, why these lemons and limes, bruv, weren't seasoning the food all this time. Do you know what I mean? What's going on? Didn't wash the chicken before you put it in the fridge, bruv. But apology. Must be tapped. Nonny. Palmer. Oh, unlucky. Good save. Good save. Come on. 33 minutes. Go on. Oh. Out for a corner. Madueke there just skinned about two men. And the thing is with him, right, no matter what he's on end product-wise, the one thing that is certified is that since he's come to this club, even last season, his take-ons and dribbles completed is always up there. He knows how to go past people. It's nice to know that he guarantees that at least, you know? He is going to go past people. That's one thing, if nothing else. Did not strike that properly. Oh, guys, don't give away the counter-attack like this. Come on. Good tackle again. Listen, Gallagher's having a performance where it's like, yo, he's in the starting 11. Fair enough. He's having a real good performance. Obviously, I'm waxing lyrical about Enzo Caicedo because the partnership is partnering, but Gallagher's making some big tackles today and scored a sick goal as well. So he's literally done everything that he needs to do in that position. The only thing, even when he was playing well, the only thing he was missing was the goals because at Palace, he was bagging them in. He's not really done that this season at all. So if he just keeps doing this, press, win the ball, score goals, keep the play ticking. That's all I need. All that, lovely jubbly, mate. That's all we need. Stay out of first phase business, though. We don't want to see you deep. We don't need to see all that. This is going to be so weird. After the meltdown, and rightly so, by the way, meltdown that we had as a fan base over the last week, if we end up winning this game and playing like this, we're just going to just have to, like, we're going to be so happy. And we're not even going to know what to even we're not even going to know how to react. We've been cussing for so long. We don't even know how to react if we do well. Do we smile? Do we laugh? Like, how does this go? What does a win feel like of this magnitude? In a game where we're not expected to win. How do we do that? What do we do? Brav. I'm really liking this performance, man. Still a couple little problems on the crosses. I'm not really too confident on dealing with them yet, but everything else is not too bad. Oh, shit. See, look at that corner. Went through everybody. Gusto. Go on, Gusto. Go on, Gusto. Go on, Gusto. Go on, bruv. Free kick for his troubles. Free kick for his troubles. Thank you, ref. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, referee. Thank you very much, referee. Because that man did not run all that way for you to go and mug him off now and let the play continue. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Couldn't get the ball off him, so you barged him. Give us the free kick, bruv. Talking about... Bro, Enzo controlling play, and then people be having the audacity to ask what is he good at. Don't make me slap you, ref. You know what I mean? And I said, this is, look, it may have been extreme, but I said on All You Can Eat Chelsea, if I have to pick between Enzo and Poch, I said I'm picking Enzo, fam. And people were like, rah, that's mad. This guy wanted Poch. I said, bro, if you think anybody's going to make me question Enzo Fernandez, Caicedo, and Lavia's ability in this midfield, I was gassed for a reason, and I'm not changing my mind. If you think any manager is going to let me question this player's ability, you're having a laugh, bruv. I'm sorry. I don't love you that much. I know what player I watched. I know why I was gassed. So you better make it work, because that brother there is a good player. So I'm not going to hear nothing else about it. You make that shit work. Put him in the right position. right side. Yeah, baddie is sure. Bit jittery. Still need to iron this out. But hopefully he just gets better as the game goes on. He's got Desassi next to him, his best mate, so doesn't really get better than that for him. Win that header. Oh, go on. Chilwell's done very well today. I'm very happy with Chilwell. This is much better. He's actually concentrating. Like, you can see Chilwell's concentrating. I can actually see the concentration through the screen. Like, he's locked in. He's locked in. He's locked in today. Watch that run. Please watch that run, Gusto. Well done. He's locked in. That's all I can say is he's locked in. Man's paying attention. Just keep doing that. Just need to get to halftime minimum with this score. Don't concede. Don't let the momentum sway. And I'll be a very, very happy man today at halftime if we can just keep this clean sheet to halftime. Ball in, cleared. Oh, my day is clear. There we go. Thanks. Free kick. 5 minutes, guys, to halftime. We just need to just keep plugging it. Keep plugging away. We're almost there, people. We really got to take it one half at a time. Like, that's how I see it. Like, 5 minutes to halftime for them to get back in. Get the praise that they need, that they deserve. Say, listen, you're doing a good job. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep playing how you're playing. I'm going to freshen a few things up in the second half if some of you get tired. All that good stuff, bruv. But just get to halftime with the 2-0. You're halfway there. Because right now, these players, like, they got to take... I'm not even saying take it game by game. You got to take it half by half. Like, they need their refreshments. You know what I mean? Their juice, all that good stuff, bruv. I don't know. They just need to take it half by half. So if they can get to that halftime break, 2-0 up, they're going to get all the praise. And the only thing that needs to be said is just concentrate, bruv. Do not... You shouldn't even have to tell these men to concentrate, because you are getting absolutely slaughtered, bruv, in the Premier League. And the pressure is on. If you don't have enough respect for yourselves to concentrate after this good first half, then there's something wrong with you. You've got to stay locked in second half. You have to. Because there's no way you can think you're too good. So just be humble, keep playing your game, and just stay switched on second half, and you'll get through the game. Because I feel like Villa, and I ain't taking no credit away from us, don't get me wrong, but I feel like Villa might be one of those teams that if we can take the confidence out of them in the second half, first 10, 15 minutes, and let them know that we're serious, that we're on serious business, and we're not going to let you come back in, and they might start to think, do you know what? We got Conference League and we're in the top four race. We don't need this, man. We're just going to just let this one go. We're going to just let this go. If we get that third goal in the second half and we just keep applying the pressure and keep playing well, they might just be like, yeah, fuck this, bruv. This is not it. We got Conference League and we got Premier League. We don't need this. And they might just let it go. They might just let it go. So, because they probably got bigger fish to fry. So, that's what we need to do. Because this is everything for us. We need this. We need this cup. So, there's no way. If Wolves wanted it more than us on the weekend, then we need to want it more than Villa today. That's how it's got to go. That's how it's got to go. Yeah, bruv, I'm stressed. Bruv, I'm stressing about the second half already, bruv. 100%. Because, you know, I know this team, bro. That's the problem. I've watched this team at home to Arsenal, bopping it about or, you know, having a great game and then just let the 2-goal lead just go. Next thing you know, we're 2-2 of Arsenal and I'm like, what's just happened? I've watched us against 9 men Tottenham playing well, but you know, it was nine men and then still almost dropping points because took ages to get the second goal and then they almost got equalizers. Bruv, I've seen it all, man, with this team. So I'm not taking nothing for granted. I'm telling you now. I'm just as shit scared as I was but when the game kicked off. I'm telling you. This game ain't over until the final whistle blows. And then even then, I'll probably still ask if it's over. Yo, I'm telling you. Even when the final whistle blows, I might still sit here for about two more minutes. Just check if it's actually done. I don't really want to, you know, I don't want to repeat offense of when Bruno Fernandes scored that penalty after full time against Brighton all those years ago. I'll probably just wait, make sure that it's really a final score, just to make sure it's really done. Don't take no risks. It's mad, you know, because this is a very inexperienced starting 11. We've got no Sterling and no Silva today. Take out Chilwell and it's basically kids. Oh, yeah, De Sassi as well. It's a lot less experience. Gusto. Plugging away, Gusto. Plugging away. Plugging away. I'm not, yeah, so someone's saying Badia Shaw's the most error-prone. I'm not going to distinguish right now because all of the defenders this season have all been error-prone. Thiago Silva's been error-prone. Colwell's been error-prone. Badia Shaw's been error-prone. I'd say De Sassi hasn't made errors leading to goal, but he's also had his own moments at times. But out of everybody, I probably remember least from him. I remember Brentford right back, not getting on the back post for the goal. I remember a few, but I don't remember as many. Whereas I remember about good 5-6 from Colwell, good 5-6 from Badia Shaw, good 5-6 from Silva. But everybody's been error-prone in their own way. I don't know what that throw-in was from Chilwell, and I don't know what it's going to, but I'm going to tell you right now, Captain, wake up, because yeah, that was wild. That was a throw-in. Let's not, brother. Bro, do you know what? Someone needs to take a picture. Someone needs to take a picture of Chilwell's face after he realized he fucked up. I'm telling you, that's a screenshot. That could be a good meme if we win this game. If we don't, it won't be funny. But his face after he dropped that ball, oh my days. He looked like he saw a ghost. That was the face of a man who thought he was getting hooked at halftime. For that alone. God damn. Iceman said my soul left my body. God damn. Halftime. Half time. I'm not even going to tweet because as much as I would love to wax lyrical about the first half and tweet, the game's not over and I can't trust. I got PTSD. I can't trust these men to just be, to be, you know, guilting me and, no, this is ridiculous. I need to read this tweet out to you from Big Six, but I'm going to read that in a minute. So we're going to wax lyrical about the first half in a bit. But then obviously we're going to move on because we got second half. We don't want to get ahead of ourselves, but I ain't tweeting because I don't need that to come back and bite me. I don't want to jinx this. Big Six tweeted, well done, Nigeria. Tagged, Tapping Tobes, Culture Cams, Maze, Ty, and Astrid. They are going to be so rattled, bruv. Oh my days, I love it. I love it. I love it. I don't know who tweeted that, but hats off to you. That is a great tweet. I know they're triggered. They're trying to enjoy. She's tweeted motivation. I swear this girl's a rattler, man. Yeah, it's mad. She's not real, bruv. She's actually not real. Fucking hell. Yeah. Anyway, mad. Half time. 2-0 to the mighty Chelsea. I don't know how we've come and performed like this. I didn't see it coming. It's almost like we've just clicked our fingers or we've pressed that button in Men in Black and we've just forgotten about all of our last week's struggles. As they said, and I'm gonna probably say this in the review because it's such a great analogy, but we are treating this like a one-night stand. We are. Because we don't want to go too far with this. We don't really know what their intentions are with our football club. We don't know. I don't know what this group's intentions are with my football club. Because the way they're playing right now is really good. Really good. There's still a couple of, you know, moments where I'm looking at them and thinking, oh, better watch that cross or, you know, better track that runner. But for the most part, two great goals, great football. On the ball, we are so much better. Like Enzo Fernandez next to Caicedo in build-up, receiving the ball off the centre-backs, coming towards the ball, picking it up, turning, picking up his head, switching play, combining with the midfield partner. This is what I've been asking for in terms of the midfield. Gallagher is higher up, winning the ball in the press. The finish for the goal is emphatic. And he's having a very good game, yeah? And he's playing a role which makes sense. He's the third midfielder. He's the third man runner. He's the Palace number 8 role, box to box, but not next to Caicedo, not doing all that, right? Madueke's been good, but obviously end product-wise, we could have had a goal. We could have had maybe more chances created, but he's been very good down that right-hand side. A lot of good things have come from that side, going past players, him and Gusto, balls into the box. Obviously, Jackson gets his header for the goal. That's brilliant as well. It's a free header. I guess if he's ever going to get a header, it's probably going to be a free header because we know maybe challenged, he's going to struggle. But that was a great pinpoint cross. And he directed the header well for once. And he aimed it well and it was great. So it's as close to a perfect first half at Villa Park as you're going to get. There's still saves having to be made from Petrovic. I'm not really surprised about that. Like, we are going to have to make saves. We are going to have to defend a bit. It's Villa away. They've had 6 shots. We've had 9. 3 on target. We've had 5. More passes, better XG, more possession. I can't argue. I cannot complain. I'm so happy. More than you can believe, guys. I'm so happy. More than you can believe. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. But do not get complacent. What you've done is only half the job. I feel like I'm doing the team talk, but you've only done half the job. You've not gone through to the 5th round against Leeds. You haven't got your flowers yet. You won't get your flowers yet. You have to finish the job off, because if you don't and you let them come back into it and you start doing some foolishness, no one's going to really remember the first half if you go out tonight, you know, or no one's going to care. So it's a knockout. It's knockouts. You gotta progress. You got to progress. Keep playing like this. That's all it is, man. It's brilliant. I'm really happy. It's actually a joy to watch the football. The football's been good. Creating chances. I don't think anybody's playing poorly. I think Badiashil still looks nervous and a bit shaky. Chilwell's much better, apart from the throw-in. Just needs to, you know, maybe dry. His hands need to be dried. I don't know if they got a Dyson hand dryer in the changing room. Just dry your hands because they're slippery. Petrovic, man, I love this keeper. Since this guy's come into the goal, I don't think he's made a mistake. Like, he might have conceded a goal, maybe where he could have saved, but I don't think more than one. I think most goals that have gone in have been completely out of his control. He's just done his job. He just brings a calmness back there. So, I don't know. I think he's definitely first choice. And I don't know after that what we do in the summer, because you know, it's a lot of pressure to put on a young keeper, but he might just be that good. I'm still waiting. I think the jury's still out. You know, we still got more games to play this season. But right now, I'm really happy with this keeper. Still, obviously, things to improve, but he's just being a goalkeeper. You know, in the modern day, you've got goalkeepers that obviously are playing out from the back, but they don't know how to save shots. Playing out from the back, but they don't know how to collect crosses. Playing out from the back, but they don't know how to... This guy's just said, I'm a goalkeeper, bro. Don't ask me about none of that extra fancy shit, bro. Just, I'm a goalkeeper, all right? I'm going to be a goalkeeper. And that's it. So, and he's good on penalties. So I'm happy, man. Buzzing. Let's see what you guys are saying on Super Chats. I ain't really got much more to say on the halftime. I don't want to get too ahead of myself because game ain't done. Job's not finished. Chilwell leading the team is a sight to see. Crying emojis. Arsenal fan here on a hit along against Villa. Go on, Chelsea. Please beat Villa. Why do you want us to beat Villa? That's interesting. I want to know why. Astrid has done some magic. Jackson is scoring headers. Clara Bitsy. Listen, he's back, innit? So let's see. He's back from AFCON. Let's see how he does on the goal tally front. It would be nice if he could hit 15 Premier League goals in his first season. That would be brilliant. Obviously this is all comps now in this game, but yeah, man, it's good to have Jackson back. It's as much as like criticism he's taken, sometimes he's been a bit socially unaware, as many of these young players had. He had to get a slap on the wrist for that, and rightly so, a couple of times. But in general, this guy is much better when we have him in the team than without. I've watched us without, and I've watched him with, and we're better with him in the team. We might not be prolific, but we play better. This guy's linking things up. He's ball retention is very good, hold up very good, ball carrying good. Just needs to find the finish, but he scored today. He's until we get someone better, which we don't have up there. He is the best striker we have at the club, because Nkuku's not a striker. He's obviously the best finisher, but he's not a striker. Until we get someone better, I'm very happy to have this man leading the line, because this is all we got. We saw what Brody was doing, and it weren't great, and now he's at Fulham. So, yeah, man, it's good to have him back. Very, very good to have him back. Poch got that Ollie Jean. Every time he's about to get the boot, he gets a wonder result. Forever in limbo. Yeah, yeah. I mean, listen, it's too early, innit? This is the first time where I've been like, disillusioned with him, like really disappointed. I've been disappointed for a while because I've criticized him a lot this season, to be honest. But this is the first time I've snapped. So now he's just trying to, you know, now I'm just interested to see if he can actually sustain a performance like this. You know, if you can do this in the first half of against Villa, can we do it in the second? Can we go and do that in the next Premier League game? Can we go and do it the game after? Like, can we keep playing like this? That's the key. You don't want to just do this once and then bin it and go back to some foolishness. You got to keep doing this. Two quick centre-backs and we press better. Thank you. yeah, listen. People thought I was making excuses. I'm not. We do need quick centre-backs if we're going to press from the front. I think that's obvious. If you play Football Manager, you know that. It's not an excuse. It's just obvious. Now, obviously, the manager could drop the line and drop the whole press and play compact and deep and counter. He doesn't want to do that. He wants to play his way, which is pressing from the front. Liverpool, Ange. So if you're going to do that, you need to have quick centre-backs. And this is why I criticise the directors for not bringing in a quick centre-back, right? But this is where it is. Like, if we're going to play press from the front, we need to be compact and we need to keep the team close together. The only way to do that is to bring the defensive line up and to press and to have some pace. The only defender with raw pace is Fofana, and he's out injured. Badiashile and De Sassi are no slouches, but they're not exactly like blistering quick. So it could be better. You know, they're not that quick. This is not a pacey backline. This is just like a decent, reasonable amount of pace. It's just not sluggish and slow. If they're on it. So, but yeah, I don't think she was the reason why he was taking out the team, to be honest. But it happened, didn't it? It happened at the same time. So take it what you want. Thoughts on Jackson on the left? I like it. Yeah, I had Jackson to start on the left against Wolves. Because, you know, Gooney was saying for the longest, you know, this guy's not a striker. I'm obviously a lot more patient on him because I always give everyone one season. And to be honest, even though he's not a clinical goal scorer, I wanted Jesus as well before Jackson. Instead of Sterling, I wanted Jesus because I think Jesus is a really good footballer, but he's not clinical. But my thing is that if you've got goal scoring wingers either side, you don't have to have a clinical, like 20 goal a season, potentially front person. If you've got 20 goals from the wide areas, we obviously don't have that. But I don't think Jackson up front, I don't think he's over. Like, I don't think he can't play up front. I just think the team needs to have certain attributes out wide if he's going to play up front, because some of the goals have got to come from somewhere, or he's got to improve the goals. But on the left, yeah, he used to play as a winger, innit? People are saying, and when you watch him, if he's good at dribbling or he's good at going past or carrying the ball, why can't he play out wide? Like, he's got better close control than Mudryk, right, in tight spaces. He's a better dribbler. So why can't he play wide? Do you know what I mean? Why can't he? He's a better dribbler than Mudryk, based on what I've seen so far from both of them at the club. So there's no reason. He does. You know, he might become a more technical Werner, where he just does play as a winger and we get a striker who finishes, and then he just plays out wide. And then he does is that he plays out wide, he retains possession, he dribbles, goes past players when he can. And then when the chance creation in terms of the pass is happening on the right, if it was an Elise, but it's a Palmer, a James, a Gusto, and he's making those back post runs and he's adding the numbers in the box, because the one problem for us is we don't get enough numbers in the box. So if you've got someone who has played as a striker, like, I mean, Liverpool, Nunes, right? Someone that has played as a striker but is now playing as a winger, they should know, I need to be in the box. If the ball's coming in off the right, I need to be on the box. There's no point at me hugging the touchline or being, I need to be in the box. And that's just an extra number. So now you've got two strikers in the box instead of one. You know, when everything's going off down the right, you've got two strikers in the box. You've got an extra person to hit. So, and he gets that header. So, yeah, I don't really mind with Jackson if he becomes a winger. I'm not really bothered. He didn't cost a lot. So I've always said he didn't cost enough to get all of the kicking he's been getting. Like, he's doing fine for his price. He didn't block anybody from getting a big name striker because he didn't cost much and he's not on loads of wages. So he's just doing his thing, man. He just has to grow up, innit? That's all it is. Like, just like so many of those other guys, they just got to grow up. Like, you're at Chelsea now. The microscope's on you. So just behave yourselves. And if you're not going to behave yourselves, then we're going to have to get some people in leadership positions that will make sure that you do. And that's all it is. And then after that, it's just train hard and go from there. But he could play out front or out wide. I don't really know what's... I think it just depends on how we build the attack, where he plays, really. Depends. We either get a goal-scoring winger on both sides, or we get a goal scorer up front. I don't really care which one it is, really. Just, we need one of them. We need goals from somewhere.
The donkeys singing Roman Abramovich, move on, new owners in town, yeehaw. Pablo Martinez. Trying to understand what you're saying, but listen, people will sing what they want in it. I don't really care if they sing Roman Abramovich's name. It's the same as singing a legend of the club in terms of a player's name. Frank Lampard, he has a song. Sing it. Like, so I don't think anybody should be taking offense if they're singing legends' names. You know, I don't think there's a problem. But if we're not performing and they're singing it because they want him back, then obviously do better, innit? Perform. Just don't be shit. They won't do that then, innit? it's not difficult, bruv. Just don't be shit. Let me get the timer up and then we're going to keep going with the super chats. Second half's about to kick off. I'm really looking forward to doing this review, man. If we keep... Because you'll see me. When we lose, bruv, the way I start the reviews, my face looked like I just got hit by... Like I got slapped, bruv, in the face. You see me, I'm just... I'm already tired before I even start talking. I'm so pissed. If we win this game playing like this, I'm gonna be a very... It's gonna be a good review, man. So 5 Michelin star. Let's see. I'm gonna have to update this timer. It's a little bit behind. Um, I just need us first 10 minutes. Just keep the ball and just play it. Just take away any team talk that Emery's given them, any motivation, any cussing, any crowd revival. I want all of that just completely nullified in the first 10 minutes of the second half. Just take the sting out of it. That's what we got to do. Just take the sting out of the game. I think they'll hopefully calm back down if we do that. They're pressing high up. Not sure why Jackson moved away from the left. We were much better when he was on the left. Says Clara. Big fan of your videos and streams. Thanks. Much appreciated, bro. Thank you for watching. Do you know what I mean? Very appreciative of the support always, every single time. I used to have a channel when I was younger that got like 30 views a video. So to have everybody here watching is mad. It's absolutely mad. I don't think you understand how mad it is. I used to be happy with 100 views, bro. So we used to drink to that. So so not this channel, different one, but yeah. So thank you. Players heard Jones was coming and went into God mode. Listen, they heard a lot. The players heard a lot. They heard about Jones. They heard about Mandem getting sacked. Directors, bro, everybody in big trouble right now. So I don't know what they heard, Mike, but they heard something. So yeah, I don't know what they heard, but they heard something, bro. But just make sure they let them hear this again after the game and for the next game and the game after that. Let them keep hearing this because they need to understand this is not a one-off in terms of this match. We need more performances like this. This win will feed the delusion of the board. The board, regardless of what's going on, the board needs to stop buying kids. Like, it's not going to change. You've bought enough. No amount of wins is going to ever make me feel like we need more children at the club. We've bought enough kids. So that has to stop regardless. I've been talking about that for months. You've had it. You've bought enough of these talents. That's enough now. So, you know, they're in trouble for that regardless. I can't lie. If they keep doing it, they're in trouble regardless for that. We're not going to be consistent this season. It's okay. Yeah, I don't think anybody was expecting consistency in terms of like, we're going to win all the time, but I think we should be better than 11th, though. I can't lie. I think we should be better than 11th. Being in 11th behind Wolves is it's not the vibe. It's not the vibe at all. It's not okay, by the way. 11th is not okay. Behind Wolves is not okay. If you start accepting that and thinking that that's okay, then you're going to start normalizing mediocrity and you're going to start becoming numb to everything that's going on in terms of the position in the league. I get, you know, realism and, you know, having reasonable expectations, but 11th, no, we're not doing that. We're not doing that at all. The only way we should be finishing 11th is if we were docked 20 points or something. Then after that, I'd understand. If we were docked 20 points, and then maybe I'd get it. But no. Minutes gone. Aston Villa coming down this left side. Goalkeepers come out. They can do one of two things in this second half. They can get the third goal and finish this game off, which would be ideal. Or they can see it out in a real professional way and manage the game, which I think is very difficult to do because they're a young team, even more so today. So I think just get the third goal would be ideal. I'm not really in my most trusting phase right now. The PTSD is mad. So I think the third goal kills it. I do. I think the third goal kills the game. It's always the way. It should always be the way. I think if you're letting a three goal lead go, then you're in big trouble, you know. You should be able to defend a three goal lead. Get there Oh, just not quite. Well done, the sassy. Well done. Here's Madueke. Right side, cutting in again. He's so dangerous on this side, carrying the ball, man. Play it now. Well done. Here's Enzo. What are we doing? Great ball. Okay, unlucky. He's gone through anyway. Let's keep that in. Palmer. Palmer cutting in. Gallagher. Lay it off. Brilliant. Unlucky. Well done. Let's go again. I'm nervous now because I'm desperate for them to see this out. Absolutely desperate for them to just see this game out and win it. I'm always nervous, bro. It's always a reason to be nervous. Oh, it's falling to Enzo. Nice 1-2. Shot from... Oh, I sweep the ball from under his feet. Referee, give him a free kick, man. Tielemans, you nasty bastard. Jesus Christ. You dirty bird, bruv. What is going on, Tielemans, bro? Enzo was about to rocket launch that into the top corner. Out here. Tripping my man up. Free kick. Who's taking this? We don't even have a free kick taker. This might be the time to bring on Nkuku. We ain't got no free kick takers. If Enzo's taking this and he crashes it in, that's the day complete. I can't lie. That's all I need. Anybody actually can crash it in and I'll lose my head because I ain't seen a long shot in a long time. I'm starving for long shots. Absolutely starving. I just don't know who's going to get enough power on the shot from this range. That's my problem. It looks like Enzo's taking it. It just doesn't feel like a very Enzo free kick situation. It feels like... If Enzo's going to take free kicks, it feels like they would be from a lot closer. I would love nothing more for this to fly into the top corner.
So let me just beg, fam. Oh my god, you don't understand. I feel like I'm on drugs. I feel like I've taken crack. Oh my god, I swear to god, I feel like I'm on drugs. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. I gotta tweet something. Oh my god, I can't breathe, bro. I needed that so much. Oh, you don't understand how much I need this. I've been defending this guy from werewolves like Cams. Oh my god, Robbie and Flex and all these. I'm not even gonna say that, bruv. Let me not switch, bruv. If I don't take this mic, I'll cuss you, man, out, bruv. Oh my days. I told you this brother's got quality. Oh my days. He's got quality, man. Don't tell me he doesn't. He's got quality, bro. The guy's got quality. I ain't saying he's always been showing it, but he's got quality. Just got to be used the right way. Because average players don't bang in shots like that. Fuck. Yeah, tell them to hold that, man. Fuck, man. I'm sick of it. Tell them to hold that.
I need more of these, man. I'm borderline on tears. I'm borderline on tears, bro. Borderline going to cry. Oh, that was needed. I needed that. I literally was asking for it. That's what's so mad. I was literally asking for it before he struck it. Like, I was praying. And I don't know why, because I really didn't think he was going to do it. I was like, it's too far out. And I ain't never even seen him hit a long shot with any conviction since he joined this club. So I just like, there's no way he's doing it. But we go and pray anyway. Please don't concede now. There we go. I can't believe it, bruv. This game doesn't feel like, it doesn't feel like us. What kind of foolishness is this? This game's been crazy. And it's so funny because he was the one that was going to shoot in the first place, and then Tielemans just took it off him. Wow. That's a taste of what this player is capable of. That's a taste. If you needed any more reason for why you stick by him and you say, listen, fuck what these rivals are telling you. We got a baller, bruv. We need to just figure it out, bruv. We got it. Just figure it out. Figure that shit out, man. Nah, you shat it, mate. Yeah? After all this shit I've been taking, bruv, I'm a milk that shit. That's a finish. Every time Kobe Mino has a good game, bruv, these men are in my mentions. I can't take this shit no more. We needed that. Yeah, it's cold celebration as well. Y'all need to leave my midfielders alone. Leave them alone. Yeah, man, that wasn't no close free kick, man. That was far out. I thought it was too far out. Because you know, with Enzo, if I'm thinking he's going to score free kicks, I'm thinking they're going to be from close and he's just going to give it the little dink. I'm not thinking he's going to generate enough power to be hitting them from there. So when that hit the back of the net, I swear to God, I thought I was tripping, bruv. Because that's the way I laid it all up and said that, yeah, please do this. And I thought, nah, this is just bullshit now. This is some bullshit. This didn't go in. There's no way. Ain't no damn way. Just over half an hour to go. Just keep doing what you're doing, man. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep doing what you're doing. No complacency, no bullshit. Here's Jackson. What a performance, man. Here's Madueke, right side. Go again. Go on. Unlucky. Deflected. Well done. Wow. People are on point today. Ball into the box, cleared. Caicedo, Gusto. You're going to get a... Is it a free kick? No? Madueke, unlucky. I really want us to keep a clean sheet, man. So hopefully we can just keep. It always makes the scoreline far more impressive if we can keep that clean sheet. It just goes to show there's not been no lapses in the performance.
for once this season, we just want a complete performance, man. Start to finish. I think the boys need that. It's about time. Got 30 minutes, man. I'd rather we don't score again and keep a clean sheet than we score again and concede. Like, I'm here for the clean sheet. I'm here for the clean sheet, man. Enzo did the same celebration when he left Benfica. He ain't leaving. Don't worry about that. He locked into that prison contract. Proper Chelsea Poch in. Big up, man. Up Nigeria. Big up, bro. Love. Well done. You're in the final. Hopefully we get to see maybe Ivory Coast there as well. That'll be a sick final. Here's Gusto. Petrovic. There we go. This team are so tapped. Come on, guys. I'm still nervous because I'm not about to see this end like 3-2 or something. Like, I'm actually just so locked in. I'm just so locked in because I just want it to just end properly. I don't want any crap. I don't want no crap to take, because I think we're going to win now. Like, I'm 3-0 up. I'm confident in these guys finishing the job off. It's just, I don't want them to ruin it. I don't want the shine to be taken off the performance with any silliness, because then it ruins the good feel factor of the performance. They got to stay locked in, man. They have to. They got to stay locked in. I still don't trust them that much. It's true. 3-0 is my score, man. 3-0 is my score. Once I see 3-0, I gotta let the PTSD just simmer down, just park it. But I just want the game. I do just want the game to be locked and done. So I just know what I'm getting. Oh dear. Ball in. Clear. Gallagher finish is so good. Gallagher, all the goals are great goals. All of the goals are great goals. The header is great because we just don't get to see it at this club at all. The free kick is obviously the best goal. It's just perfect. Jackson's a joker in that celebration. But they're all great goals. All of them great goals. Buddy Show, Enzo. Oh. Get back. Buddy Show, come on, get back. The sassy. There we go. Well done. Oh my God, don't let him through. White. Got to be a bit stronger than that, man. Come on. Is that Caicedo? No. Gusto. Weak. Come on, weak. They saw the byline quotes. Good. If that's where it's taken, then good. Good. Because that was a wild week. Someone had to hold corn. I don't really care who, but everybody had to get it. I can't lie. So after that Wolves game, bro, everybody had to get it. I'm sorry. Everybody had to hold that smoke. Everybody. Every pillar and post of the club had to hold smoke. I'm sorry. I don't take nothing back. You man absolutely, bro. You know, you just get a game sometimes that will just actually just enrage you. Man United away was one of them. Bro, you have to hold that. Like, I'm not in the business of saying that, like, because we support them and we support the club, that they're always right. It's not customer is always right, bro. Like, no, this is not how this goes. Like, sometimes you man actually have to hold that because you're taking the piss. You man have to hold that. You have to. They turned down the shot error in user ability. Funny. 1-0 Ivory Coast. Yeah, they need to know this is a serious club that you play for, bro. A serious club. Might not be in a serious position, but you play for a serious club. And fans are not going to tolerate bullshit, bro. There's got to be a bit of give and take with this process thing. Can't be out here taking a piss. Man, they're my 11th, bro. Palmer. Gusto. There we go. Well done. All right. Let's go again. Keep the ball. There we go. There we go. Well done. Gusto's been good. Yeah. Yeah. I'm happy, man. I'm happy with the fullbacks today. Been much better. Considering what's been going on in the last couple of games, again, getting absolutely destroyed by Cunha and Neto and everybody. So, fullbacks have been much, much better today. Midfield's been on point. Oh, heavy touch. Badia Shield, well done. Good tackle. Palmer. Ooh, Madueke in behind. There we go. Gusto. Round again. De Sassi. Caicedo. Caicedo, come on. Let's keep it simple. Let's not do stupid shit. It's not every time we have to do something mad. You can just play it safe, you know? Just play it safe. If you ain't got no options. Come on, man. We're 3-0 up. We don't need to do anything extra now. That's it. Look after the football. All this is now is maturity and game management and just do the simple, just do the basics, man, because we're 3-0 up. Oh, shit. Big block De Sassi. Big fucking block De Sassi. Come on. Big block. I need that block because I need this clean sheet. Well, we need to pattern up. Big block, man. Great positioning. Well done.
Ball in. Petrovic, come.
Yes. My goalkeeper. Yeah, my goalkeeper. Come claim them. Come claim them crosses. Right, they're going to make some subs now. Can't believe it, bruv. And obviously, if Saeed's doing his scouting report, then he's looking at this Villa team thinking, what the fuck is this, bruv? But what subs would you guys make now? What subs would you make? What subs would you make? I'm trying to remember who's on the bench. Oh, go on, defend. Come on, guys. Stop this. Cut it out. Come on. There we go. Come on. I'm very boxed in right now. Come on, guys. Let's get out of here, man. We might need to make some subs. Because, we've lost our way a bit now. I'm not trying to see a goal go in. Come on. We need to be proactive. Yeah, we need to make a change, I think. I don't know. Certain men are tired or what, but we're a bit camped in. Gusto. He's going to have to clear. Oh my dear, it's fucking old Petrovic. So, come on. Right, 73 minutes. What are we doing? What are we doing subs-wise? We got... I think we need to do something now. What a tackle, De Sassi. Brilliant performance. Yeah, Poch. Hey, Poch, let's go. Rise and shine. Wakey, wakey, mate. It's time to do something. Time to make a sub. Let's get some fresh legs in there. Let's go. That's enough. Wakey, wakey, mate. Rise and shine. Let's go. Let's get a sub on. Let's get some fresh legs, man. Let's keep this intensity high. Sterling's coming on. For Madueke. I think Madueke is the right one to come off as well, because I'd say he needs a bit of a rest. He's been working hard. He's been working hard. Been up and down that right side. We need to be tracking runners. Sterling better be tracking that runner when he's on. Better be tracking that runner. We've got Carney on the bench. Mudrick on the bench. Who else? Alfie on the bench. Who else is on that bench? Bear players injured. I can't even remember who else is on there. Two keepers. I think. Silver as well, yeah. Silver. Oh, shit. If we're gonna... No, go on. Clear, clear, clear. Yeah, Gusto. If we're gonna go... If it's gonna be like this to the end, right? Then this might be the time to go to the five and just bring on Silver, because we're playing deep anyway. We got a deep line. So there's no spacing behind anyway. Bring on Silva. Put him in the middle of the two centre-backs. And then you've got Gusto and Chilwell on the wing-back positions. Maybe go to a three. Just to give a bit extra. Just an extra person to win headers in the box when the cross is coming. Just let Silva see the game out. That might be a play. I can't really think of who else we'd bring on defensively, unless you're bringing on Alfie Gilchrist for Gusto. I don't know. But last 5 minutes to be 80% possession for them. So either we need to get back control of the game, or we need to sort out ourselves defensively. One or the other. Listen, I ain't really, this ain't the league, and it's the cup, so the league table hasn't moved. So they wanted to leave the mid-table mafia. So yeah, it's no problem. I understand. Big up, Joe. I understand. If they want to leave, they can leave. But better make sure you win games, though. Don't make me find you back next to me again. Otherwise, this time we won't be letting you go. This time you'll be staying with us. Winning this trophy somehow would be our get out of jail. Yeah, it would, because it gets you a Europa League. It's true. This is the one trophy that we could win, and we could actually get away with to a degree. And I say to a degree because, you know, if you finish 11th, I'm going to remember. It doesn't matter what you do, I'm going to remember. But unless you win the Champions League, then I don't remember anything, because at that point I'm probably blacked out. But yeah, if you win the FA Cup, then yeah, you do manage to miraculously get what you needed minimum, which was Europa League. There's a long way to go in the FA Cup though, so. But it is the only competition that can rectify the league. But long way to go. We take it game by game, half by half. I think Caicedo is probably just tired. So I'm not too worried about that situation. Silva's coming on. I think he's just tired. Or he's, I don't know. Hopefully it's something minor. Because after seeing this midfield, if I have to see another injury and a different midfield, I'm honestly just going to just give up. But I think he's just tired, and I think he might be just time wasting and just saying, I'm going to lie here and I'm going to make sure that I take my maximum amount of time on this. I don't think he's got anything wrong. Yeah, he's good. He's all good. So, who's coming on? Is there another sub? Thiago Silva's coming on. And I think it's going to be for an attacker. Or he's gonna go to a back three. 25. Caicedo's coming off for Nkuku. So very attacking change. So Jackson and Nkuku up front. Loads of instructions and information being given to the players by Poch and his coaching staff on the sidelines. And Cole Palmer's going to come off for Thiago Silva. So no Caicedo, no Palmer. So Sterling, Nkuku, Jackson. Silva comes in to go into the middle of the defence. To make it a three. Gusto, Chilwell. And then the midfield is Enzo and Gallagher. So it's a 3-4-3. Gallagher next to Enzo. Back three. Wing backs. Front three. Sterling and Jackson out wide. In Cuckoo, I think, down the middle. I think. So, yeah. I'm happy with those subs. Caicedo had to come off because we can't be taking risks. And Gallagher will just... hopefully just go next to Enzo and just put the miles in till the end of the game. But yeah, back three. Surely with a back three, three centre backs, two wing backs, surely we can just see this game out in the right way. Is Caicedo still on? Oh, is he? Because I saw his number go up. Are you sure? I see Gallagher. I see Enzo. I don't see him. Because I saw his number 25 go up. Oh, is he? Is that him coming back on? Oh. Wait, hold on a second. What? So who did he take off then? If he's not taking off Caicedo, who's he taking off? Sterling. Oh, he hasn't brought on Nkunku. Oh. So, guys, he was going to bring on Nkunku because it was 25 coming off for 18. But I think maybe Caicedo said, listen, I'm fine. And then they've decided, no, I'm not going to do that. Because I don't think they wanted to do that. I think that was going to be a forced change. But Caicedo's just come back on and Nkunku never came on. Fair enough. I think it was going to be a forced change, but they didn't want to change it because the numbers did go up. But yeah, because he was literally standing there as well, ready to come on. So, all right. It's even more defensive then. I can't lie. I don't really care who comes on. I just want my 3-0. I really don't care. I'm not asked. Not interested. Whoever he feels is the best to finish this game off right tactically, that's the players that should come on. This is not a time to bring on Twitter's favourite players. I don't give a shit about none of that. I really don't care. I want a 3-0 win. Mature, professional, see the game out. No goals conceded. Go home. Enjoy the game. I'm not trying to see nothing. It's results time. It's results time. It's not time for giving charity minutes. No, results. And emphatic results as well. If you really want to bounce back. Team need to learn how to see out a game properly. Every single time we try and see out a win, we concede goals and we just about get through it. This team needs to see out a win. They need to see out a win properly for once. It's more important than anybody else getting minutes. And they're going to learn today. Full 90 minutes is important. Take the game seriously. That's the fucking standards, guys. That's the fucking standards, yeah? That's real Chelsea standards right there. Close them down. Clear? Good. Yeah? That's the real fucking standards. Nah, yeah, I don't care about none of this. Not interested. Need to learn to read the room at the club, bruv. This is a time for a serious performance. It's not time for more kids to come on. I'm not interested. Anybody who throws that at me, I'm gonna shut it down, I'm afraid. Just not the time at all. Not the time. This club is on its last legs. Last legs. Is that Baddie Ashill coming off now? Fuck's sake, man. Baddie Ashill injured, guys. Coming off. I don't know if it's precaution or what, but these doctors at Chelsea, they're busy, bruv. They're busy. I don't know if that's a groin injury or what's going on, but Alfie Gilchrist had to come on. And he's going to play left side centre back. In a three. And he's not the tallest, but... Oh, dear. There's always an injury everywhere. Anytime around the corner. He's actually had a much better game today, Baddie Ashill. Like, this would have been a nice little building block for him. But if he's got problems, then I don't know. Jackson's come off as well. Nkuku's come on last couple of minutes. Yeah, I think he should be okay. Hopefully. He didn't look bad, but, you know, it would just be nice if people could just be completely healthy, you know, not carrying a knock. And we find out later on this week it's worse than we thought, or we have to delay his return, all this nonsense. It would just be nice if no one picked up anything for a week or two. Give us a bit of rest. We will never have a fully fit squad. I'm aiming for a strong, you know, 3-4 injuries max. That would be a peak. That would be a great moment if we could hit that. You know, three injuries in the team maximum. That would be like, that would be a real, real step in the right direction. Look at them fighting, bruv. Go on. Fighting for this ball. That's what we want to see at the end of the game. These men should be playing in the last 3 or 4 minutes like it's the first 3 or 4 minutes. Like, it's, they owe it. They owe it to the fans in the away end. They owe it to themselves. And if they actually like this manager, then they owe it to his job security. Honestly, they have to. When I say locked in, bruv, I mean locked in today. I'm not even playing. See me? I'm locked in. I'm not even calling Saeed. I'm locked in, bro. I'm locked into the final whistle today, bro. I'm done playing with this lot. I want my clean sheet and I want my perfect performance that I can just like properly praise. No negatives, no lack of concentration, immaturity in the last 10 minutes. Just proper job. Proper Chelsea, proper job. That's all I'm interested in, bro. Because you can't count many games where we've actually done that this season, start to finish. And that has to change. So nah, it's not calm until the final whistle, mate. I want a clean sheet. We don't rest. Yeah, see, look. There you are. Ball's on the left side. Clipped in. Corner again. Ain't easy, bruv, innit? Ain't easy. Keeping these clean sheets ain't easy, bruv. Ball. Out wide, long shot, blocked again. Reverse pass, cut back, and then bang. Great finish, to be fair. It's a great finish. But it's 3-1. Shame. One thing I will say is that it is a great goal. It's a shame that we couldn't get out to that person to stop that shot. But at least it's not a individual error or some stupid shit. It is a good goal. And it is right in the corner as well. But yeah, just got to try and get these clean sheets, man, at some point. Not today. But hopefully there's not much added on time and it just finishes 3-1 and we keep it moving on the review. I don't want to see 10 minutes added on now. Here's Sterling. Nice. Well done, Gallagher. That was real good. That was real good. So only 3 minutes left. No more goals conceded. Let's go. A couple minutes to go. Yeah, 3-1s. Listen, aim for the moon. You'll find yourself amongst the stars. I wanted a 3-0 just to keep the clean sheet. I've ended up in a 3-1. Listen, if you told me before the game we'd win the game 3-1, I would have absolutely took it, and I would have laughed. So no complaints. Just do not concede another one, please. Because then you start to make the scoreline look a lot closer than it should be. Come on, guys, man. See, look how close we are to conceding another one, man. That's what I'm talking about. That's why you got to stay locked in all game. Header. Cross coming in. Saved by Petrovic again. Proper keeper, man. Got a good feeling about this kid. Good touch. What a touch in Cuckoo. What a touch. What a touch. Brilliant play. Hold up. Run the clock down. Run it down. Keep the ball. Run it down. Run this clock down, please. Guys, come on, man. There we go. Keep it. Yeah, brilliant. Go on. And Cuckoo. Oh, go on. Oh, it could have been 4. Unlucky. Nice idea, Gallagher. Oh, lovely. Oh, brilliant, Gallagher. Brilliant in that corner. Brilliant in that corner from Gallagher. Lovely close control. Love it. Everybody in that midfield today has been top-notch. I think we got our goal of the season at Chelsea in that Enzo free kick. Can't lie. I think we got our goal of the season. We don't really get many of them, so I think he's pretty much bagged it. Wow. I don't want to take too much time to talk here because we've got a review to do, but that is as good as it gets, man. That is as good as it gets for where we were last week, where we were confidence-wise to come and win at Aston Villa, which I said in the first game, in the review of the 0-0, that, you know, I thought we could come here and do well, but that was before all of the madness last week. So, you know, we took the replay and that's why it's just, you know, it's better to just play again. You know what I mean? Like, to be honest, we don't have European football. We shouldn't really be afraid of replays. If we have to play a replay because we have to just about get out in the first game, then it is what it is. We turn these into our two-legged Champions League ties, to be honest. make the FA Cup the Champions League and turn it into two-legged affairs. I don't care, as long as we get through. unbelievable win. Unbelievable win. I'm really, really buzzing because that's a tough place to go. Any top team, even at their best right now, would be happy with that. So for us to go there in all the crap that we're on, yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I'm shocked, to be honest. So let's go. Oh, Saeed's got something to say, yeah? Okay. All right. We'll do this quick. He did say we'd win. I thought he was just trolling. He didn't even give me a reason as to why he thought we'd win. That's the funny thing. He didn't give me a reason. He just said, we're going to win. And I'm like, all right. Fair enough. See if he picks up. I'm relieved. Absolutely relieved. Honestly. So, so relieved. Oh, I need these cups. All right, brother's not picking up, man. I got a review to do. All right, listen, I'm ending it there, people. Raps, smash up the likes, subscribe, review coming ASAP. And All You Can Eat Chelsea is tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. Buzzing. We needed that as a fan base. We needed that. Let's go. Love and guidance. In a bit, people. Peace.